That was a much tamer weird noise than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, that's a little tame.
Oh, I love that art.
I think the mic cut it out mostly.
Yeah.
I'm gonna cry. You should redo
right.
it.
You can still redo it.
Is that just Zhao? Yeah.
It is. Yeah.
All right. Well, hello, everybody. For those of you who are on stream, which I'm pretty sure is like nobody right now, which is fine. We're not using cameras today because we're all tired and exhausted. For the rest of you,
my hair though, looks like the greatest I have ever had. That's disappointing.
For the rest of you, the reason you can't see is because you are dead. So, last session,
not
you
dead.
Guys. You guys delved beneath the radiance section of the city into the sewers to investigate a little bit about some potentially shady figures, which you saw. They attacked on sight. You dispatched most of them. One of them blew themselves up. And the last one led you right into a maze in which your party got separated, and then separated again. So, for the three of you who are not dead, you're still in the room with the mysterious statue, of which Barry is absolutely certain has some sort of evil mind-altering effect. So, we will resume there.
I have
Do
a question.
Do our characters know that our other teammates are in danger?
Nope.
The light did go out, though.
Yeah, all we know is that the light went out a while ago.
And, yep.
And we haven't
and
seen them
we
since.
We haven't heard from the others basically since we got separated. So, did my staring down the statue and intimidating the crap out of it have any effect on its hold on Thamus?
I thought Thamus was staring at an ivy wall.
Correct.
He was next to the ivy wall, yeah. Thamus, why don't you go ahead and make a wisdom saving throw with advantage, keeping in mind that you have the negative modifier from the ivy.
Trying to find the negative modifier right now. I cannot find a negative modifier.
It was a minus four on whatever you have.
So minus four. It would be 13.
Yeah. Sure. Yeah. You feel like the urge to stay has been lessened, though your feelings of the statue's friendly, it's fine, have not. But you are no longer compelled to remain in this area.
Okay.
Man, nobody got to slap him.
You can still slap him.
Somebody slap him.
Slapping him is not a
Famous and just Mac.
So, Eden, Thamus, we should probably go leave the room, do some more investigating, see if we can find the rest of the party that we haven't seen in.
Yeah, I would like to not be in the dark anymore. I really can't see a thing.
You know.
Well, I can see a little bit.
I don't really want to, but you have a fair point. Very well. Let's go search for them.
Can I use you as transport again, Barry?
Absolutely.
Thank you. Absolutely.
Now, I would like you all to keep in mind that as a bear, Noel, you can't speak. So up until this point, there have just been a lot of vague gestures of like, but I'll say that the rest of you get the gist.
Just really good Usher raids.
I'm gesturing towards the door with my giant paw.
All right.
And I just gesture towards your back. It's like, hey.
All right. In that case, I assume that you guys are heading back through. Are you following the orange line one-to-one? You're not straying off of that path, going straight back to the beginning. Or are you going to spread out and search a little bit wider?
I think we should probably go back to where the rest of the group got separated off. So following the orange line.
Yeah, we would just follow the line.
Okay. For the sake of brevity, because I don't need you guys going all the way through a maze. I'm gonna put you all in what you may find a peculiar spot of the maze. But I would like you all to make a perception check.
Are we in dim light right now, or are we in darkness?
You are. So I would really just like Barry to make a perception check. Because the rest of you are blind.
Yeah.
Well, actually, no, there's eventual torchlight coming down the hallway. I just need to see if you notice something.
15.
And that you do. Victor, as you are rifling through in your investigation, this cultist, you hear some very strange noises coming from the wall above you, and just as Barry, you walk through and you notice, that one's not dead. Who's that? And Victor, you look up and you notice that is a giant brown bear.
Orange.
It's painted orange for some reason. It's not an orange bear. It's a brown bear. It's painted orange.
Oh. With me riding on top.
with a human female with very, very poofy hair riding on top. And
is Momo in Eden's hair?
Yes, she wouldn't be able to see Momo, he wouldn't be able to see Momo at the moment.
Wow.
Who are you?
This is a little hard to explain.
A friend. Okay. Cool.
I'm not here to cause any harm.
That's good.
I followed a group in here, and I was investigating a bit.
Find anything of interest?
I don't know. Did I find anything of interest?
You found a couple things in their pockets. You find, and you'll have to add these to your character sheet yourself. Just go into your inventory. And then I believe you can, hit manage inventory and add custom item. So the first thing that you find is a set of what look like almost marbles. They just look like black beads or marbles.
How do I make a custom item? I'm so sorry.
Yep. So go into your right there. Yep. There you go. So go ahead and add those to your sheet. You also find from the other dude in the chamber a book bound in black leather. It is empty. So that is what you come across of, as well as from the third guy who, well, self-immolated down here. You got a couple of scraps of burned paper. They don't say much. You'll need to investigate that in a bit.
Okay.
So, overall, just a couple of items, but not anything too groundbreaking.
I did find a couple of things. But, nothing much.
Okay. Cool.
Are you guys a part of the group that I followed down here? I heard of a bit of an investigation happening.
We did have a group, but I don't know if it was the same group you were following.
I don't know if anybody else would come down here.
At that point, Victor, you do see Themis wandering behind Barry and Eden, and you do recognize him.
Interesting.
As the owner of the Violet Inn. The Violet Thorn Inn.
Oh, so I recognize.
So you know for sure this is the group.
Okay. Yeah. Did you guys get separated?
We did. We're actually trying to find them now. I don't suppose you're good at finding people?
So, it's actually my job description.
Well, fancy that. What are the odds?
Do you need some help?
Sure, why not? You know, the more the merrier in a dark cave. With strange people running around.
Sounds fun to me.
Okay. Victor, I assume you're going to walk up to the rest of the party.
Yes, I walk up.
Yeah, okay. I would like you to make a perception check. I just want to see something.
Okay, how do I do that?
So you don't have your physical dice yet, right?
No, not yet.
All right, and your character sheet? You see where it says perception +7? Click on that +7.
Okay. 19.
Okay. You can hear from this top corridor. Echoes of something else moving around.
What does it sound like?
Scraping. It doesn't have a real specific sound. It just sounds like something's moving around.
There's something over there.
Yeah, and it's not necessarily like right there, real close. It sounds like it's echoing down from the chamber a little bit.
Okay.
You also notice some watery footprints go going up and around.
Interesting. Is this the direction that the rest of your group went?
This hall? I believe so. Yeah. I think I remember two of our teammates going down there.
Something's in there.
I hope it's my teammates because I miss them and they're very, very handy light source.
Jesus, okay.
I mean, hey.
Well, the only way to figure out if what's over there is to, you know, go and investigate.
At this point, I'm going to sort of gesture to Eden to step down off of the bear tiger.
I step down. Just stop.
And I am going to return to my human form.
So you watch Victor as this strange sight of somebody riding a bear painted orange. Quickly, she hops off and the bear just turns into another person.
Oh, wow. That's quite interesting.
Yeah, I have not gotten used to that myself.
Eden, you still have orange paint all over your ass and your legs.
He still owes me a doorknob.
Fine. This is fine.
It's a fashion statement.
Yeah, it's simply a fashion statement.
Could be a witch.
Themis looks always so much worse though, because Themis fell into the water.
Oh,
earlier,
right.
Yeah. And then ran his face into several orange painted walls.
Yep. He sure did.
It could be a worse color.
I turn to Barry and I go, you know what? I'm just glad you didn't have any paint on you when you broke my doorknob.
I might have forgotten that I did that, but thank you for the reminder that I still owe you for a door.
Not a door, just a doorknob.
Just a doorknob.
Well, I mean, I had to get out the door one way or another. That wasn't my fault.
No, the window was
okay.
He technically broke the window, but it was with his back flying through the air.
Yeah.
Right.
Which was not on purpose.
Okay.
He was that guy thrown out of the window meme. But as a bear. Wait, no, it was before he turned into a bear, right?
It was before he turned it. He got thrown through the window and then turned into a bear, I believe, and ran back through the window. Anyways, Barry, you are now no longer an orange-painted bear.
And somehow I'm not an orange-painted human. I don't understand how that works.
Magical paint.
Magic.
The magical paint.
The mysteries of Barry are universal level.
That bear fur is just a really, really good insulator.
There's that. So, okay. And now I'm going to cast Goodberry. It says that I need a sprig of mistletoe. Would we expect that a druid would have that? Oh, I've got an herbalism kit, so that would make sense.
And also, given your theme, I would also allow you to use honey as a substitute for that spell anyways. So.
Okay. Well, and these are Goodberries spelled B-E-A-R-Y. They look very much like gummy bears. And I'm going to distribute them to everybody around and say, here, take these in case we need them.
Okay, so there are 10
say,
total.
In case we need them, I slowly pop it out of my mouth. Like, oh.
So, Barry, there are 10 total. I'm gonna let you guys decide on how they're distributed, but
I am going to give 4 each to Eden and Thamus. And I'm going to give 2 to our new friend.
Okay. Victor, you have 2 good berries. You can add them into your inventory as just custom items. They are enough food for a whole day if you eat one, and it also regains 1 hit point. All right, with the berries distributed, what's next for our group?
We go find our teammate.
Yep.
Yeah.
Can I get a marching order?
The blind one in the back.
I'll follow behind Barry.
Yeah, I would probably be the one to go first because I have dark vision.
How well can I see?
Just like
Victor also has dark vision.
Okay. Also, Thamus and Eden, if you have anything to produce light, I do have druidcraft, and I can light it for you.
I pull out a candle.
I have a torch. I just forgot about
that. Also,
a torch is better. Well, I still pull out my candle.
Yeah.
It's a good idea for everyone to have a light source in case we get split up.
Okay, keep in mind that holding that item will take one of your hands.
Yes.
That's fine.
All right.
If I don't need it, I can just throw it on the floor. Hopefully not start a fire.
Eden, you have a torch?
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to be holding this torch?
Yeah.
All right. Boom. And then, Thamus, you have a candle.
Yep.
Just going to be a little bit less, we're going to say that. All right. With that, Eden and Thamus, you now have some visibility. I was going to point out that you could grab a torch from the wall over here as well, but it seems like you guys have it covered.
Though I might actually go over there and just grab it for extra.
You never know when you need it, you know?
Yeah.
So now you have 2 lit torches.
And no free hands.
No free hands.
Careful.
Fine, I can throw.
Careful with your hair. You are carrying 2 very flammable items.
It's fine. If my hair gets caught on fire, I'm sure the creature in it will quickly alert me. By the way, Victor, this is Momo.
Victor,
let us down here.
You see, poking out between the giant foliage of hair, 2 very, very large eyes. If you have ever seen a picture of a bush baby, that's what it is.
And now the saddest thing about doing this no cam is we don't get to see Moo do the voice.
I am very glad.
I mean,
it's all right. It's all right. Tori is missing at the moment, so
true.
What a cute friend you have there.
Thanks.
All right, where is Victor in the marching order? If we have Barry and then Eden and then Thamus, are you at the end or you?
I could be at the end. Yeah.
All right. I do want to point out maybe the logic of putting an investigator at the end of the group, but
yeah, I thought Thamus was supposed to be at the end.
Maybe we could put me more up if that would be more helpful.
Yeah,
I mean, I could switch spots with you.
We could also put the investigator in the lead since they would be able to see and or hear.
Well, he could carry the extra torch, right? So.
Yeah, I could.
So he could be in the lead.
I just slowly hold out this torch, like, hey, do you want to take this so I don't set my hair on fire?
Yeah, I'd take the torch, so...
Okay.
Thank you so much.
There you go. You now have a torch. I'll put you in the lead there. So, you are in a maze, so couch, start going through. And everybody else, be quick on the follow. I would like you to keep track of how far you've moved, because you can move 30 feet in one round. And,
30. That was 30 for me, I think.
Yep. Victor, you will know actually the way to go because you can see the footprints on the ground, so you'll know to go this way.
Okay. So we keep going?
Yep. Everybody's following you.
And actually not getting separated.
All right, you see the footprints take a turn off to the left-hand side here. And it's about this time, Victor, that you notice something else.
Okay.
There are the remains of webs covering the wall. Ooh. And it looks like there's some blood on the floor.
That can't be good.
And the footprints continue this way. They go back for a second, and then that's where you see the blood.
Does the rest of the party see this, or just Victor?
Victor's passive perception is the highest of anybody.
Even Nova? Or
yeah.
Well, especially now.
Yeah, especially now. He's at zero HP.
Okay.
Based on your earlier observation of hearing, you can hear the scraping a lot more now.
Okay, so did the footprints continue forward?
Yes. All right, that's 10 feet.
Oh boy.
Spot. They go down here first.
Okay.
15, 20, 25, 30. I will allow you one action, and then I would like everybody to roll initiative.
I don't know what to do here.
You have your hand crossbows on. You're holding a torch, so you don't have both of them, but you are able to make an attack on one of these if you would like. And the way you do that is in your page where it says hand crossbow and it says hit DC with that plus 6, just click on that and tell me the number.
Wait, so how do I do that?
In your actions tab. Are you in your actions tab?
Wow. Yeah, I clicked the plus 6 on one of them.
And
it did not roll very good. I got a 9.
Okay. You walk into what is very obviously a giant spider den. And you are so freaked out. Like, oh, that's what was making the noise. You shoot your crossbow and it just completely misses. It hits the wall. Everybody go ahead and roll initiative and then put it into the chat. So catch that is just the one that says initiative with the plus four.
Oof. You know what number I like again? It's
oh eight. No.
It. I rolled a 12.
Put it into the roll 20 chat.
Okay.
Do us dead people roll too?
Nope. You're dead.
Thought so. I just wanted to double check.
Okay. That's a lot of low rolls.
We're all tired. Not much initiative today.
Nice knowing you guys.
All right. And Barry taking up the end. Well, let's see if they go before or after you. They go before you. All right.
What happened to the dice that likes us, huh?
That was it.
I don't like your dice anymore.
It decided that you split the party and deserve to die.
it's probably right.
The first spider to go is actually kind of out of your guys' view. And it's going to actually crawl up the corner, and it can't do much from there. So that means, Victor, you are up first. Remember, you have movement, action, and bonus action.
Mm-hmm.
Since you are, this is your first ever combat, if you want some advice, I will give you some advice.
I'd appreciate it.
Okay, so you can't use your bonus action to attack again, but you can use it to use insightful fighting. I would move out of the way a little bit so that your team can get in. So I would move to here. And I would shoot the biggest thing on the board if I were you. Insightful fighting is an insight check against a deception check. And then, so you can go ahead and roll that.
Insight?
Yep.
25.
I rolled a 9, and I don't think a spider has a positive charisma modifier, if I could hazard a guess. So now you may make an attack roll.
Wait, did I get a nat 20? Sorry.
Okay. On insight, what did you roll?
A 20.
Yeah, you did.
What the heck?
I'll give you advantage. Go ahead and roll.
Yay.
If you go to your hand crossbow and right click the plus 6, you can select advantage and go ahead and roll.
Twelve
to hit. With advantage?
Yeah, gave me 1.
Oh no. Unfortunately, that does not hit.
You spent all of your luck on that 20. So sorry.
Oops. All right. Well, yeah, that's rough. Okay. That's you know what? I would maybe use the rest of your turn to actually go back here.
Okay. I'll do that.
That's my advice for you there.
I'll just be in this little corner.
Yeah. Next spooter is going to... It's going to be the big one. And it is actually going to try to shoot at you, Victor. So, oof. Okay, that's like a 7 to hit or something. So yeah, that doesn't hit it. You see that it shoots up like a blob of web, and it hits the wall next to you, slightly steaming.
Oh gosh.
Next up is Themis. You can hear some scuttling behind the party right now.
Can I peek my head out around the corner?
Yes, you can.
Okay, just speaking. Ah. Okay. Well,
hello there.
I pull out my dagger and I throw it at the teeny spider. Well, not teeny. Human-sized spider.
All right.
So
now you can just... So for your lighting, you have 10 feet of dim light.
Yes.
Is it currently being shown on by Eden?
I do not know.
Or do you still have your... Oh, you have night vision on active. Here, let me disable that. There you go. Can you still see it?
I can see the outlines.
Of the spider?
Yep.
Okay. Then go ahead and... if it's an attack roll, if you can see any part of it in bright light, then make it as a straight roll.
No part of it is in bright light.
All right, then that's a disadvantage.
Oh goodness, I'm gonna lose my dagger. Hey, so you know the funny thing about disadvantage is when you roll a nat 20 and a nat 1.
Yeah! Popo!
That's really sad.
That's devastating.
You know what? You know what? Roll a d20 and just tell me the outcome.
Another nat 20.
What in God's name?
Nice!
Fuck it. You land gracious. A crit. Okay. You land a crit. Go ahead.
We got Jesus on this team.
The annoying thing is, it's a dagger. It does 4 damage maximum.
Yep. Yep.
That is a 2... I'm gonna do piercing damage. 2 piercing damage.
2 piercing damage. Voter is not letting me change its health. There we go.
And I'm gonna go back inside, because I do not like it. And that is my turn.
I don't like it.
So you walk out, you see the spider mandibles going wild. You throw the dagger, like, it so looks like it's
gonna
miss.
Wait, sorry, if it's right. A crit, then it would be 8 damage. Because we're doubling right. It, right? Yeah.
Unless your dex modifier gets included with that.
I do not know the breakdown.
It only doubles the dice.
It's just 1d4.
You don't have a dex modifier?
No, the raw damage is just 1d4. Because my dex is still +0 at this point.
Oh, okay.
Gotcha. That's why. Okay, yeah. That's why I was asking. I was like, "Yeah, that's why your AC is shit, huh?"
That's why my initiative is shit.
All of our initiatives was shit.
Yeah.
Okay. So, you threw the dagger. It looked like it was gonna completely miss, and it managed catching it on the leg. But it very could have easily just gone through
Which
all of the legs.
Leg?
It's got 8 of them, man. Pick one. I don't know.
All right, front leg. I'm sure that will be easier to retrieve later.
I see. All right. Next up in initiative is another Spoder. Spoder. It's going to be this one, and it's going to follow behind the other
so
one.
So glad these aren't centipedes.
Eden, you are up.
Will. I am stuck and have nowhere to move.
I will allow you to push past Barry for a difficult terrain.
Yeah. Barry, can I squeeze past you to go peek in that little entrance? See what we're dealing with? Apparently not.
Barry tries to talk and just nothing comes out. It's just bastards.
Yeah. Oh, good lord.
I was muted, yay.
Yeah.
I'm squeezing up against the wall as flat as I possibly can.
All right.
Only semi-rough terrain.
Disadvantage, right?
Wait,
I have to throw my torch. I don't know.
Yeah, you do have your torch on. So what are you doing?
Okay. Are the spider webs looking flammable?
A little bit.
Okay, I'm gonna chuck the torch at the largest spider web I see.
Oh no.
This is not going to be a good idea.
There are people in there.
Why are you doing that?
What did you roll?
I haven't rolled yet. What do I roll?
Oh, why did this have to happen?
Okay, the closest thing next to the spider.
Wait, oh no, you're gonna perma them.
No, I'm not. I have insulation, right?
It's spider webs. That shit is so flammable.
So I check it on the spider, not the spider webs.
I would say don't chuck it.
I can roll up a new character!
Because if you miss...
I miss.
Is anybody else here able to touch fire for a little bit? Or is it just me?
From what you noticed, Victor, it looks like probably just you.
Please don't toss it at the webs.
Can I pass my torch to you, Victor? Just so I can actually load my weapon.
Victor's already holding a torch.
No, the weapon. Hey, Barry, you want to hold a torch?
There doesn't happen to be a sconce on the wall or something, does there?
You can't just drop the torch at your feet.
I feel like I would light myself on fire. But yeah,
don't
sure,
stop
that works.
On it. It's a torch.
Cat, you literally.
Do I need to use druidcraft to put the torch out?
Oh my god. It'll be fine, I said. There's no way they could mess this up. You were going to light them on fire!
Okay, is not the torch on the floor. Do I roll disadvantage because of light, or what is it? Is it just straight?
The light is still happening as long as the fire is on. I need a minute. Go ahead and roll.
Oh my god. That's a 25.
Let's have some flambéed characters.
Yeah, that fucking hits. What are you shooting at? What are you shooting at?
That thing.
What?
Nothing.
The small
spider?
One?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Go ahead, roll.
It's a no four.
Bug. Yeah.
Four damage.
Yeah, four piercing, right?
Go
four
back.
Piercing. Okay.
Go back to the VOD. Clip that. Send it to me.
Okay.
Look, I thought I might do something.
It would have been very smart if there weren't the bodies of your friend in the web.
Technically, Eden doesn't know that.
You can see the outline. They're wrapped up like mummies.
It's humanoid size fucking cocoon.
Maybe that's subconscious, okay?
Okay. Well, fine. Is that your turn? What else?
I'm gonna squeeze a sperry so I can return to my spot again. And so
okay.
I'm not blocking the way.
Alright. My cat has come to comfort me.
I'm sorry. Just wanted to be helpful.
I guess last is the spoder who is going to actually, let's see. Barry, you go first.
Okay. So first thing I'm going to do is yell at everybody around me, go find the others. And then I'm going to...
I think I found the others and I tried to light them on fire.
Step into the room. And I'm going to... apparently Victor's the only one that's going to be able to see as I start to turn into a bear. But extra arms come out of my shoulders and my hips. And I'm turning into a spider.
A biter.
Giant spider. Yeah, it's a
spider bear.
Spider bear. That's a stretch, but we'll take it.
Spy bear.
Spy bear sounds like a spy though.
No, but it's spy bear with eyes.
Oh my god.
What about a bearder?
We're speaking this aloud. This is a spoken game.
It's Spy Bear. Take it or leave it.
Right.
And now I fix this.
All right.
I'm an eight-legged
Victor.
Tank.
It's horrifying. Honestly, it's like a regular bear, and then more bear legs shoot up from the shoulders and the hips and then back down. Like it's as it turns around, you see that it just has like eight eyes on its face. It's very, very disturbing.
I'm for claws art.
Way ahead of ya.
Didn't we already have that?
We did.
Yeah, I already drew it once, guys.
He has it on the stream already.
Oh my gosh, you're so ahead of the game.
All right.
So now I get to attack as a spider now, right?
Yes, sir.
It's like spy versus spy.
Except fight it's spider, spider with spider. Versus spider.
Yeah, sorry, fight spider with spider.
Needed to find my wild shape thing.
Yeah, I mean, don't sweat it. You've got a lot more sheets to work with than anybody else besides maybe me.
Yeah. Yeah, so, okay. I have spider climb, web sense, and web walker.
Okay.
And also, I have bite and web.
Yes. This entire room is full of webs, and you can feel there are two spiders up here, and then you've got the big one and this one, and that's it. There are no more creatures moving in here.
So I think I'm going to... Let's see. Five to hit, that doesn't do any actual damage, but bite does. So I'm going to bite the big spider.
All right, you bite at the big spider, who is honestly just so confused.
It's what I like to hear.
Go ahead and roll.
So it's plus five to hit. It is a 16.
That hits.
And D8. There it is. So it is a D8 plus 3. That would be a 4.
Yeah, that's, oh, it doesn't matter because the minimum amount of damage you will do will kill this thing. So this spider, you notice now that it is very damaged. You can see sword marks on its legs. It's leaking some sort of weird spider fluid. It is very obviously not doing well already. And as you go in there and you say, "Hey, I can do that," and then you can kind of do it, tell me how you take this thing out.
So I am going to use my four front bear legs, and I'm going to grab the four front spider legs of my foe, and I am going to sink my fangs into the soft underbelly of this horrific giant spider.
That you do. It's just bug guts coming out of this thing as it flaps to the ground, all of its giant legs slowly curling up. And it is a goner. Barry, anything else for your turn?
I think I'm going to... I think I'm going to stay where I'm at, because I should still have some movement. But the shift, the wild form would be my bonus, and I did my attack. So I'm just going to stay where I'm at next to this little spider.
All right, and that little spider does indeed try to attack you. Its tiny fangs cannot pierce the hide of a grizzly bear, even if it's a grizzly spy bear. And it attacks you and misses, which brings us back to Victor with one of those other spiders on deck.
What?
Your turn, Cash.
Okay. I'm gonna move forward after witnessing that crazy battle. Oh my god. Let's watch a spy bear kill a spider. Is there any way I can...
Would you like more advice?
Yeah.
All right, so I would stay there, and I would use your bonus action to take the hide action. What hide allows you to do is make a stealth roll. So go ahead and make a stealth roll for me.
Oh, yes, the action I always forgot to do.
Well, we weren't fucking around with that in the trial campaign.
Got 21.
21, okay. That'll do. That means what you can do now is you have an advantage with your crossbow shot. So you can shoot this spider with advantage.
Okay.
So go ahead and make an attack roll.
Which one do I?
The crossbow.
Crossbow. I'm silly. I got 23.
Yeah, that hits. Go ahead and roll the damage on the spider. So that is the one right next to your to hit, which is the 1d6 plus 4. And because you are rolling this at advantage, scroll down to your sneak attack, which is 2d6, and roll that as well.
Okay, so wait. All right. Eight, and then eight again.
Eight, and then eight again. After your miss, you take a moment to steady yourself, hide, peek around the corner, and you shoot that spider dead.
Yeah.
That will, unless you want to move around at all.
I think I might want to move a little bit more in.
All right, go ahead and move in. You have 30 feet of movement. Anywhere else? You do notice, by the way, there are definitely some figures in the webs against the back wall.
Okay. I think I'm good right here for now.
Okay.
Well, there are, next to the spider.
There aren't any more spiders in the room as well. Okay. Obviously.
Maybe I move a little bit more in to see if I can take a little peek at what's going on with these with these humanoid shaped webs.
All right. You will, on your next action, you'll be able to take a peek at them, since you used your bonus action and action to shoot this turn. Next up then is a spider. Spider's going to roll up here and is going to take a bite at Themis. That is a 13 to hit, which hits you, I believe.
Yep.
And that is 4 piercing damage and 2 poison damage. So, Themis, it is now your turn.
One moment. Updating health. Is this the same spider that I shot?
Has the dagger in its leg, yes.
Okay.
You can notice that it's no longer using that leg as there is like fluid leaking out of it.
Either... Also, keeping in mind that the last thing Barry said before disappearing into the room was, find the others.
Either way, I have to do object interaction to grab it, so I'm gonna make it cool. I'm gonna mage hand it out of him.
Oh, all right.
I'm gonna cast mage hand to pull the dagger.
Just quickly, for the sake of the spider being able to move, can you roll a dexterity check?
Sure. 11.
That'll do it. As the spider goes up and bites at you, you take the opportunity to magically whisk the dagger out of its leg and return it to you.
And then, because I'm a little low, I'm going to use my bonus action to cast Healing Word as a... Wait, we have 3 players down, right? Okay, 3 players. I'm going to cast Healing Word as a second level spell on myself.
All right.
Which would bring me back to 5 plus 3 is 8. It will bring me back to 16. Back where I started before this bitch attacked me. And that is, well, I have movement, so I think I want to push in a little bit. Wait, no, because there's this spider that is now engaged with me. Okay, I can't really move. All right, I'm going to stay.
That's all right. Next up is a spider who is going to go up and go over and can't do much, but will attempt to shoot a web in at you. So, Nova, do you remember if I use a saving throw or an attack roll for the webs?
Me?
Yeah.
It was saving throw, I think. Oh, wait, no. No, it was a saving throw, yeah. It was.
Yeah, so, Themis, go ahead and make a dexterity saving throw.
Not one.
Ooh. Okay. You are currently, let me get in here with this. You currently are webbed. So you are restrained. And I guess we will just pick up with, who's up next? Eden is. Eden, it is your go. Themis just got kind of... He just got a shit rocked by a spider and was like, oh no, I have to heal myself. And then he just got trapped by the other spider.
I don't suppose I can go pick that torch up and like...
light me on fire?
Say I'm on fire?
Oh my god, what is with you and lighting your teammates on fire?
You're on fire.
You have a problem.
Are you in... Is he in danger? Like...
very clearly in danger, yes.
Oh, okay.
And then the spiders,
once they webbed, would just come for me or something.
Then the voice in your head says, it echoes with the voice of Barry saying, find the others.
How am I supposed to find the others? Can I try and unweb him with my hand?
Yes.
Cool. Wow, something that actually works.
Go ahead, just make a strength check for me.
Okay. That would be an 11.
Okay, so it is enough for you to, if you want to, pull both of you off to the side and Demas out of the web.
Yeah.
Okay,
and I'll
you
just
do
say,
so.
Hey, are you okay?
Destroying the web.
Do they take opportunity attack on me?
No, this is forced movement. Okay. Technically.
Yeah.
All right, Eden, that was your action, though. So anything else on your turn?
I still have movement, right?
Yes.
Wait, sorry, what happened to my candle when I got webbed?
Well, you were holding it.
Mm-hmm.
You did roll a natural one.
The Seamus is now on fire.
Let's say you dropped it and take 2 points of fire damage.
Okay.
You are no longer holding the candle. Good point. Good point.
I'll just move over here, by the way. Okay, that's my turn.
Because the character with 33 HP... Jesus Christ.
Okay, look.
You realize you
I'm
have
over...
more HP than everybody on the team, right?
No. I can't see everybody's HP.
Yeah, you have more HP than everybody
on the team.
You
have a lot of HP.
So maybe I'll go inside.
You're not a rogue anymore.
Yeah.
Well... my point was, you just dragged Themis away from these spiders and then left him for the spiders.
but maybe when Barry said find the others, she realized that maybe he had a trick up his sleeve.
Yeah, and I was simply making way for Themis to escape so then I could go fight the spiders. Yeah, mm-hmm. That's my entire thought process. Thank you.
All right, well,
not a
whatever,
bad point,
whatever,
not a bad
whatever
point.
Your choice is, it is Barry's turn.
Okay, well, so I noticed that only one of the members of the party has followed me into the room. So I'm going to go and see what is happening outside the room. And I know there was a spider over in how do I make this do this thing. Are you able to see that?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Okay.
So keep
so
in
I
mind
knew there was, I knew there was a spider there.
All of these squares will be difficult terrain for you. It will be half movement.
Okay. So if I go, wait, which, oops, I did a thing. I think that would have been 10 feet of movement there. Is that correct?
You were here, yep, so 10 feet of movement.
Okay. So if I go out there, I have 10 more feet of movement.
Well, yeah, we'll call it up to here, and then you would have that would be 20 feet of movement, and then if you have 30, you make it this far, because it takes a little bit to squeeze into the space.
Yeah. So, okay.
So, that's 20 feet of movement total.
Can I use my spider climb, which also does 30 feet?
So spider climb just means that if you are moving up a vertical surface with your movement, you have 30 feet. So you won't be able to use both, because it would be like if you were out in the open and climbing a tree, that's 30 feet up.
Okay.
Or if you're on the ground, that's 30 feet on the ground. So you can move currently only one more square, and that's all you can do.
Okay. I'm curious as to why I cannot see to my right.
That's a wall.
Is it? Okay. So I have...
You have eight eyes, and none of them can see through walls.
That is rude. All right.
I need to get you a ninth eye that can see only through walls.
If it can see only through walls, then it just always sees nothing, right? It can't see anything else.
Yeah. he'd be a nice stud finder, though.
I know there was a spider this way, so I'm going to go there. Obviously, I can't do anything attack-wise. Can I?
You can use your action to dash, even as a different creature.
Okay. So then I'm going to continue.
You could make it this far.
I will go. Come on, there we go. Hey, look, there's a spider. There's two spiders.
There is two spiders.
I'm sort of overlapping, so I guess technically I would be like here.
Yeah. All right.
Did they mistake it for their mother spider?
Absolutely not.
It was worth a shot.
All right. In that case, Victor, it is your turn. You have currently one of those weird humanoid-shaped webs in front of you. Would you like to investigate it?
Yes, I would like to investigate it.
There's definitely a person in there.
You hear a voice in your head. It says, light this on fire.
No.
Victor takes the torch.
I'll get you out of there.
He must do his duty.
you can use you have a implement to cut open the webs if you would like to use your action to do that.
Yes, I should probably do that. I'm gonna use my sharp item to open the
web.
You
have a rapier, yeah. So you carefully slice open the web, and you see the body of what looks to be an elf. They're wearing a mask over their face with just holes for the eyes. You can tell that they look like they're almost gone. They aren't dead. If you would like to use your bonus action to give them the good berry that you have, one of the two, you may do so with the knowledge that you will have to lift their mask to do so.
Will there be like really bad consequences?
You don't know, but it is just a wooden mask.
feel like I would feel bad because, you know, the mask is might be there for a reason. So I'll give the good berry, but I take off the mask, I look away, and I just put the berry in this person's mouth, and I put the mask back on.
Okay. Tore.
Imagine I can't, no, hold on, I can't imagine
it
just,
was Victor
just like, yeah, just trying so hard to find the mouth.
Yeah, you lift the berry like,
no, that's a nostril.
Oop, that's not, okay.
Like,
yep.
Snorting a berry.
like you misjudge the distance and just punch him straight in the face.
Yeah. Now bro's gone.
With that, I am fully dead.
And with that, yeah, he has perished.
Tori takes 1 point of
snorting up a good berry.
1 point of good berry damage. Tori, you are currently paralyzed. You are at 1 HP. You are no longer functionally dead. You have a point of exhaustion, and you cannot move right now.
Okay.
Oh.
If I can't move, I'm just going to stare at
it. Is that Lester's time to shine?
Who's this?
No, Lester.
Yo, Lester!
It's Lester's time to shine.
At the moment, and don't forget to update your HP, you don't have to worry about Lesser Restoration. The paralysis you can feel is... when you first wake up, Tori, it's very, very strong. You can't move anything. But as you wait a couple seconds throughout Victor's turn, you can start to blink. Not that anybody can fucking see it.
Well, you guys know I have eyelids now. Right.
Spoiler alert.
Man has eyelids. All right.
You're going to tell me you have teeth?
What?
You know he's not a lizard now.
Tori, please update your health on roll 20. Thank you.
Oh, right.
Now, that means at the end of your turn, it is the spoder up here's turn, unless, Victor, you wish to take any more movement.
I move towards the other bodies to take a good look, you know?
Okay. You can move. I mean, you can move up to the ones over here if you want.
Yeah, I think I'll move like right here.
All right. You see two more similarly wrapped. There is actually a third one up here. So with that, it is Spoder turn. Spoder's going to move down here into where the web was and go ahead and take another bite at Themis. For a tasty snack, that is a natural 20.
Okay.
I don't think he can kill you. No, he could kill you if I roll both fours.
He could fully, yeah.
That is 6 piercing damage.
Yes.
And 4 poison damage.
Okay.
All right. At the end of your turn, Themis. Eden, it is your turn.
Okay. Can I, like...
Wait, did you skip me?
I take Themis's hands. Can I just, like...
Oh, you're right. It is actually Themis's turn first. Correct. Okay. Sorry, I thought I was
the other side. Please move,
then. I'm going to take my action to disengage.
Okay.
And then... To go out of it, is it 10 feet of movement, or is it 5?
I'll say that it is 5 because you disengaged.
Okay, 5.
As Barry is standing
let's
up here rattling
here.
In such a way to say, run!
let's say I go, like, here. And then I will
so
bonus
as
action.
You run into the room, you see, yes, you see the corpses of two spiders, Victor standing over by the other two at the bottom wall, and Tore is still partially wrapped in webs around him, stuck to the floor, unmoving. but breathing.
Okay, well, he's breathing. He's fine. I don't want to really just keep myself up because we still have two people down. But because we have two people down, I think I can afford to do this. I'm gonna cast another healing word on myself, just a first level spell, just to keep myself
okay.
up. Alright, that heals me for 6, and I... Wait, no, that's not 6. That is 5. That heals me for 5. And I... That's my turn. I'll end my turn there.
Alright. At the end of your turn, it's the other spotter's turn, who goes to attack the bear once again, not getting through that thick grizzly hide. It is ineffective. Eden, it's now your turn with Barryend.
Yay! I can do things! I'm just gonna shoot that guy. Straight roll, right?
Straight roll. Because you have the torch on the ground.
Right. That would be a 23.
Complete miss. Absolute trash. Go ahead and roll damage.
Oh, darn. Definitely not 7 piercing damage then, since I missed.
That is just enough to take this thing out.
Yay! So
you take an arrow at the spider that was just having a big old snack with your friend Themis there, and you put another arrow down its gullet, not the snack it was expecting. Barry, it is your turn.
I am biting this little spider that is right next to me.
Alright.
That is a 12 to hit.
12 just hits.
Ha. And we got 8.
8 points of piercing damage. You bite at the spider and you take off 2 of its legs, but it is still going.
Barry's got some good chompers.
They're bear / spider fangs. So let's see, that would be action. What can I do for a bonus? Because I'm not leaving this little spider until it is dead. Can I do much of anything?
I can't. If you're, yeah, if it doesn't specify that you have a bonus action, then you don't really.
Yeah. Okay, well, I will just sit here and rattle in such a way that makes the spider think twice about its life choices.
Are you going to do like the... the freaking spider mating dance, like the tarantula one, where like a guy has his legs and like moves it up and down. All right.
I'm not looking for a date.
Right. I meant more of a just like, this is what spiders do, I think.
Yeah, I saw a documentary once.
Yeah, right. All right. In that case, we come back to Victor.
So,
here's your spider dance.
Yeah, the peacock spider mating dance.
Yeah.
Of course, PBS, a very popular channel in the world of Volthoon.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
All right, Victor, you have...
In like 2.2 seconds.
All right, Victor, you have 2 more wrapped up what you now know to be actual bodies in front of you. Okay. I couldn't make that out. What was that?
So I probably take my rapier and, you know, go ham.
All right, which one?
This one.
Okay. You cut that one open. Do you use your bonus action to feed them your other berry?
Yes.
All right. So you As you reveal it, you see a almost sickly blue individual. They are an Illidrin elf. And as you feed them a berry, their eyes shoot open. Kyrus, you come back with 1 HP. You are paralyzed. You have 1 level of exhaustion.
I get back.
All right. At the end of your turn, Victor, it is Themis's go.
Okay, so I see Victor doing that. I'm going to use my movement to get to this one. And I'm going to pull out my other dagger and try to break this cocoon.
Okay, it is relatively easy. You unveil who you know as Krios. Victor, you see an individual not quite sure what species they are, but you see that they are wearing a goat skull mask. Themis, you may, if you would like, give them one of the good berries or cast a healing spell.
Because they're wearing a mask, I'm going to use a healing spell instead.
Krios, you return. You are not paralyzed. You're at 1 HP. You get up and are able to move.
Can I look around very quickly and see Kyrus behind me?
You do see Kyrus with a tiefling man you've never met before, kind of getting them awake and alive.
Oh, is it?
Can I go hug her?
You can't. She's on the ground still, like attached to the floor via spider webs.
I don't care. I'm hugging her.
So are you.
She's able to pull it off. Or he's able to pull off the webs and move over. Go ahead and update your health and roll 20, please. Just double click on your character and you'll see that bar 3 is red.
There we go.
Yeah, there you go. So, actually, how much healing, Themis, did Krios receive?
6.
6 HP. So you're at 6. In that case, I think it is. Yeah, because that other spider would have gone before Themis. So it is now the spider next to Barry, who is going to again bite hopelessly at the giant creature. That is a 16 to hit.
AC on the bear is a 14, or on the spider bear.
That is 2 piercing damage, and do you have any sort of poison immunity or resistance?
As a spider, looking. It doesn't say so.
Okay, in that case, you take 2 piercing damage and 1 point of poison damage. Very important that I had to know about your resistances to poison damage when it was only going to do 1 either way. Eden, you are up.
Amazing okay. Roll.
Mm-mm.
I'm going to take a few steps over here and just like gently step over the dead spider. Well, actually, I'll just
be gentle. Tried to kill you.
Spoot that. That still don't want to harm it.
That one didn't try to kill Eden. Just me.
Yeah.
My statement stands.
I'm just gonna shoot that thing.
Ooh,
that is in...
Now, 20. Question. The torch at this point is over here.
Okay.
So, it would be dim light. You'd still be able to see it via reflections off of the cave wall. But it mm-hmm. would be at disadvantage. As well as you are shooting from
itself.
You can't really see all of it, although at this point, I don't know that it matters too much. Just go ahead and roll your roll at disadvantage.
21.
That hits. Go ahead and roll damage.
10 piercing damage.
And that will do it. We are out of combat. You have saved 3 out of 3 people who were dead and dying.
Woo!
We almost killed
with
them all.
That, we will take a break. A real quick 5 to 10 minute break. So go ahead, get some snacks.
IRL short rest.
IRL short
IRL
rest.
Short rest, yes.
Oh, what does Victor look like? I thought it was like a regular person because of the.
Yeah, well, we don't exactly have character art for him, unfortunately.
I do, but it's like. My friend said I could use the art, by the way. So.
Okay.
I do have
we
art.
We could put that in.
Yeah.
Not today, it's not.
Not right, today, exactly. But we can put it in.
You should put it in the group chat. I want to see.
Yeah, do that.
So, all right, guys. Well, we will be back in 5 to 10 minutes. Have fun.
Exit. My cat feeding my other cat's food. Couch.
Cat's couch. Food.
Couch.
Yeah, this like, is a very couch. Disappointing lack of loading.
Couch.
Oh, that's cool.
What file is it saved as?
It's not saved
as... It's just saved as file. You have to open it up in, like, Chrome or whatever.
Is it a PNG? It is a PNG. Alright, let me re-upload this for you. There you go.
Yo!
He looks cool.
That's so good!
Yes, my friends are crazy.
Oh,
I can support this fact. They are crazy.
I mean,
have we?
I also surround myself with crazy friends.
Have we gotten? Has anyone gotten back from the artist yet? Sorry, we're still
okay.
Character. Hold on, we're still alive. Don't bash them. We're still alive.
I have my character. I sent it to you.
Right, you're right. Anyone else? I'll take that as a no. Alright. I'm gonna try to get your character art in right now. No promises, though. Copy here. Rename. Well, because we're taking a break, guys, I'm gonna use the scene that we've never used before.
Whoa, new scene.
You'll hear people in and out chat, you'll hear people in and out as they come in from break and stuff. But I think because we're all pretty tired, you won't really hear much from us today, unfortunately.
We CP.
I'm currently focusing on doodles.
I'm making sure one cat doesn't eat another cat's food. Jackson's fat and likes to eat everybody's food.
We do not fat shame our cat.
I'm not fat shaming. Man just likes to eat everybody's food so nobody else gets to eat.
Oh, this image is gigantic.
It's not my fault.
No, gigantic is good. That means I don't have to spend a lot of computing power to rescale it.
Isn't the hair rendering so good, Clausy?
Yes.
Oh yeah, this is art by my friend Slime Wool. Hold on.
This is Slime's art?
Yes! Have you not seen any of Slime's art?
I've never seen their art before.
It's so good. It's always baffling.
I've never seen slime art before.
So much art of my character because of slime. And a couple of my other friends.
You have one for me.
Yes. I got more caffeine.
Yo, share.
Whoa,
share,
caffeine.
Share.
It's a monster.
Share, what kind?
The Wama Melon.
Oh, that's what I actually like.
An energy drink.
I will split the energy drink. I was drinking coffee, but now I need an energy drink.
Monsters don't do anything for me. I just like the taste. Unless they have peach in them. Peach is disgusting.
I actually kind of like the, like, I like the peachy ones.
I just don't like peach. Peach is ucky.
I'm so sad and crying, man.
Good.
I have expressed my opinions on you not liking peach.
Yes, I know. It's ironic, okay?
Why is it ironic?
Funny. I'm from Georgia.
Oh, you are from Georgia. That is ironic.
It's okay.
My fruit is a peach.
I don't like lobster.
Fair enough.
Your state fruit is a lobster?
Yep.
Mm.
Definitely.
Yummy.
You never heard? Lobster the fruit? Lobster the fruit, right?
I thought it was a vegetable.
Maybe I was wrong.
I got strawberry shortcakes downstairs. I'll be right back.
Yo, share?
I have pavlova and brownie.
I just have pizza because I made it for session and then wasn't able to eat it because session started.
Typical.
At least without the camera, I don't have to worry about like going off frame to take a bite.
Yeah, that's true.
Or, you know, dropping out the bottom of the frame. Gee.
Listen, I'm lazy. I have too many buttons to press, but just all y'all. I don't need more buttons to press just for me.
Alright, once everybody gets back in, we can resume.
I think I need another stream deck in my life. I think I need to get like the 2 XLs.
We just need somebody to do this for us.
No. I'm still gonna do this for a little bit. I think if we...
I mean, we could also just not stream it.
And what, record it? You know I still have to do live editing, right? Because editing a 4-hour VOD is a pain.
I mean, we could just play the game.
Where's the fun in that?
But we have a fan base of 3 people who care about it.
Y'all... Like, if you all want to stop streaming, we can. Just keep in mind that y'all were the ones who wanted this.
3 people? There's 9 people watching right now.
Don't forget to count us.
Most of them are us, but
we're
Hey, maybe like one of them is one of my friends.
Kat, make sure you do what I told you to do about getting access to logins, because I think next week you're gonna start getting things to post for us.
I'm sorry, that was a thing I was having to do.
He only told you like, you know, a month ago.
Multiple times across
two months ago.
The entire
time. Then I would not remember. You're gonna have to send me that again.
Or you can, you know, there's this nifty feature on Discord called the search bar.
There's also the snippy
feature
IRL. I don't
even know what to search for.
Doing something when you're told instead of waiting a month and forgetting about it.
But yeah, please, 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 do that so we can start posting. You guys in the chat, make sure to follow us on our socials. We do not have a command for it.
So just like log into TikTok and Twitter and Instagram.
You have to make an account for our password manager so that I can share you the password there.
Okay.
But
all right, is everybody back?
I think so.
Claus, you back?
Yeah, I've been here.
All right, I just needed to make sure because you were muted. All right, let's jump back into the game. Excuse me, hiccups. Let's jump back into the game. You guys have dispatched all of the immediate danger. So let me know what do you do next?
Am I still paralyzed?
Yeah.
Can I, even though I'm paralyzed, can I, like, ever so slightly try and lean into Krios' hug?
Make a con save?
Con save?
I love the confusion. I love making my DM confused.
This is just you. It's every character 16. You play.
You are able to move exactly 1 inch.
You know what? I'll take it.
Kairos, or not Kairos, no.
Wrong character!
Krios kind of just holds her and apologizes for failing her.
Too many kings.
Really, really quietly.
No!
And then he looks to the other people around him and kind of is like, he looks kind of far away, like he's thinking of something else. And then says,
"You know they
came
can't
back
see your
for
face,
us,
right?"
I know, but that's what he looks like. Imagine it. but he just says, "You came back for us." He sounds really odd.
I almost tried to light you on fire, and I'm really sorry.
You what?
She did. She did.
You what? No, no, because Ian's not even in the room.
You know,
no,
Ian's
still in the hallway. I'm not.
I'm somehow not surprised. Am I able
just
to move,
to move
around at all?
Those of you who are paralyzed, you will be paralyzed for another minute and a half.
Oh, we're chilling.
Tiefling man, come here.
Tiefling man, come here.
Can Krios attempt to pick Kairos up?
Oh, you can attempt, all right. Go ahead and make
with my questionable
just
strength.
A level of exhaustion.
Go ahead and
point.
Yeah, you. She doesn't actually have a level of exhaustion.
I tap Krios. Oh, okay. I tap Krios on the shoulder and give him a look. And you have Bardic, which is a D6.
Go ahead
thank
and,
you.
And make an athletics check. And you may add a D6 to it if you'd like.
I have to roll the d6, right?
Yeah.
Okay, one sec. Let me actually get my dice out.
Make sure you
yes,
use
you
a really good d6.
Okay. Where is it? There we go. That's a full-on 6, so we're getting an 18.
Now, here's the issue.
Mm-hmm.
Kairos is pretty heavy on account of the armor that they're wearing. I will say that you don't absolutely just drop your friend and do the single point of damage to
kill
him.
That'd be devastating.
We got more good berries. It's all good.
You aren't able to fully lift them up.
Man, these darn twig arms.
You snap two vertebra on the way up.
You hear a lot of crunching in your back.
So Barry is going to unspider.
Okay, you unspider. Let me get that for you.
Oh, good. I have to hide that image.
Right. And then I'm going to re-enter the room. But as I'm entering the room, I still actually have extra arms and extra legs that are sort of still
they're
no,
still turning back in.
I do
and
not like
so
that imagery.
And so I come in and I go, "Ooh, I'm a spider."
It's well, not the right time for making jokes.
I will stab you, Barry.
We'll stab
and
you.
I don't remember how much movement I have, but I'm going to come over here and stand on my on my
My your foot goes right through and into a mess of bug guts.
This is funny because on the observer cam, you are on top of the corpse. On my player cam, you are under the corpse.
He accidentally stepped into the web sack, and so he's just stuck.
You are permanently affixed to the corpse of a spider now.
And I'm going to encourage everybody that we should take a short rest so that I can regain my wild shape slots.
While
two of your friends kind of don't have an option for the next minute and a half.
Yeah, well.
Yeah. When do I get Song of Rest? Song do I have breath. It right now?
Let me double check. In the meantime, a short rest does take an hour, so talk amongst yourselves. I don't know. Are you just going to sit in silence for an hour?
Are we talking for an hour?
Tiefling man.
Not even talk a little bit.
Not IRL.
Yeah. We should probably, like, introduce ourselves to our new friend and get to know about them a little bit.
Oh, yeah. I never actually said thank you for helping.
Yes. Yes, you do have Song of Rest.
So, I do, perfect.
Well, describe how you interact with that.
Well, I think first things first, Demas is actually going to go back to the room where he got webbed and grab his dagger that was on the floor, because presumably I also dropped that. Yeah. And then I'll walk back to exactly where I'm standing right now because I'm lazy and I do not want to move my token. And I'll hold the dagger and you see it glow and then it flashes and it turns into a flute and he's going to play it.
Yo! That's
so you guys all hear a drawn out, almost haunting fitting of the atmosphere as he starts to play. You are at the very least calmed by it, but you can feel, if any of you choose to spend hit dice to regain hit points, you will regain an extra 1d6. And you can feel that the song alleviates a little bit of the pain that you had been feeling before.
Does that include me too, by the way?
Well, it says if you or any friendly creatures. Oh, so I assume yes.
Perfect.
Can we take a short rest, yeah?
Yes, you guys may take a short rest.
The way I can do a 1d6 of healing, is that?
So when you guys take a short rest, you can do something called burning hit dice. If you go to your in your character sheet and you hit short rest, it'll show you how many hit dice you have. You should have, I think, 3 right now. For every hit dice that you burn, it will do whatever your HP dice is. So for instance, Thamus is a bard, he gets a d8. So for him, it would be a d8 plus a constitution, and you roll one of those and you get that amount of hit points back. If you choose to do that, you get an extra d6. So Barry, if you did that right now, you just heal back your HP before you get to use the d6, but yeah. So you have to burn a hit dice in order to get this bonus. But for those of you at full health, you don't really need to do that.
Oh, it's +2, so...
So go ahead and update your HP on roll 20 if you are burning hit dice.
I'm burning hit dice.
I have a 20 max.
All right, I wasn't sure.
Can you explain that one more time? I did not. It did not register. So wait.
Hit the short rest button in D&D Beyond.
Mm-hmm.
You can see it says, it should say druid, and then it'll say your hit dice.
Mm-hmm.
What's your hit dice amount?
It's 1d8 plus 2.
All right, so when you click one of those buttons, it will roll 1d8 plus 2 healing, one of the three boxes. For you, you probably only want to do one because you're only missing a certain amount of hit points. And then you'll spend the hit dice. You get half of your hit dice back for every time you long rest.
Okay.
So it'll heal you. Now, if you do heal with hit dice at the moment, you would get an extra d6 of healing, but you can't go past your max healing. So for you, it doesn't matter. But for the rest of them, it does, because they were obviously dropped down to zero.
Oh, okay. The extra d6 is from
the song.
Yep.
Okay.
Yes.
Actually, you know what? I'm not going to do that. I'm going to walk over here and get one of the good berries from Eden.
Okay.
I will give you a good berry.
And I am going to eat that good berry and take my one point of healing.
I believe, Eden, now you have 3, and Themis, you still have 4.
Yep.
Keep in mind, these only last for 24 hours. At the end of this day, they will go away. All right. Krios, did you decide to burn any hit dice?
How do I... I'm trying to do it. It's just not working.
Roll them for you when you pick the slots. It, yeah. You have to roll them with the bottom left thing in D&D Beyond.
Oh.
Nope, you can roll it.
Or you can do it in person.
So if you hit the short rest button, you'll see 3 little boxes for the hit dice. You can click all 3 of them.
I already did that. I need to...
And then it'll show the D8 plus whatever, and you can just roll it directly on there, or you can roll them manually.
I got a 6.
Are you only rolling one, or are you rolling all 3?
Actually, I should probably roll all 3.
For hit dice, honestly, guys, I would just use D&D Beyond, because it keeps track of things easier. But yeah, just keep that in mind. Short rests, it is a little bit confusing with the hit dice and stuff, but...
Could I call Victor over to my paralyzed body?
My paralyzed body.
At this point, you will have recovered. First, the muscles in your face will come back, and then you can move your fingers and toes, and eventually, you still feel very stiff, and you do still have a point of exhaustion.
Come here, tiefling, whose name I do not know. Hi, what's your name?
What's your name?
My name is Victor.
What languages do you know?
Tori.
Hush now.
A couple. Hush now.
It's a valid question.
But you do not need...
Please do tell.
But you do not need to use that tone, my friend.
Hush now, Themis. What languages do you know?
At this point, Victor, you would probably feel safe saying common and infernal. That last one you probably wouldn't want to talk about.
I'm not trying to get into your personal details. I was just wondering if I could talk to you privately.
Yes, common and infernal.
Okay, what did you see when you were healing me?
Wait, Mr. Languageman doesn't speak Infernal?
I don't. I just keep it in a hushed tone.
I did not see anything.
Insight.
Go ahead and roll Insight.
11. Not good.
You don't know who this person is. So you're Fabby, they look a little uncomfortable with the idea of you accusing them.
I'm not accusing, I'm asking.
No, you're accusing. you're not 100% sure, but they do look a little bit uncomfortable with the way that you're...
Very well.
Can I tell them to shut up in Elvish?
Very well, thank you for your help.
Yes.
If you did and you're not telling me, please keep it down.
I promise you, I did not see a thing.
Thank you.
Tori, my friend, do you speak Elvish?
Yes.
In Elvish, I yell at him and I go, "Watch your tone when you are talking to someone else."
I did thank him, but I'm being careful.
You're not being careful. You are being cold.
You are being rude, and that is my
not as
job.
Cold as he was before.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Is there some pun on how I was dead?
No? Yes.
Okay, cool.
I am ignoring that.
I have funny.
I am not ignoring that. I'm over here laughing.
Look, it's a relatively big deal. Sorry if you don't understand, but I must exercise caution.
Oh, we understand. But by being cold, we're still in Elvish. Right?
No, you can't understand any of that.
Being cold is not the way to go when someone just healed you.
Well, I
did. And brought
you
back from the dead.
I did say.
Being cold will draw attention to you. Which, if you're trying to exercise caution and restraint, is not the way to go.
Okay. Thank you. I did thank him.
Thanking is not always enough.
I'll turn to Victor and say, "Victor, you're my new best friend. How's that?" Fully, while maintaining eye contact with Themis, just to be like, fine.
Fine, Dad. Oh my god. Make me play with the neighbor kid.
You are lucky you're not getting charged for your stay.
Thank you for your generosity.
I return back to common language, and I thank him as well.
I
replied, "My pleasure."
I'm also just gonna thank, I think, Victor and also Themis.
No. Barry's gonna stand over here and take a swig out of a flask that none of you know is just full of straight honey.
Jesus Christ! Sounds so disgusting.
I would drink that.
And so you keep the flask inverted for a good 30 seconds, right?
Yeah.
It takes
yeah, right.
We're really concerned about your drinking problem.
You gotta scoop it out a little bit.
You're really digging into that. Are you okay?
Don't.
And I just like, yeah.
He just completely brings out a spoon too and starts like trying to scoop it out.
Don't wild shape into a baby because you will get botulism.
Oh?
Fair. That's the greatest of his concerns, yes.
I would use the honey, man.
I don't think you can wild shape into a child.
You can wild shape into anything.
Am I unparalyzed enough to hug Krios back yet?
Yes, you're unparalyzed. Also, Krios, please update your HP in roll 20.
Oh, right. I fully hug Krios and just like sit there for a minute. Woo!
While that's happening, Themis is going to turn to the group.
What a cute couple.
You could not make it more obvious, I'm sorry, but
you know what, switching playlist back to that playlist.
This several times.
Sorry, they are best friends.
Q, careless
roommates.
Not that one.
And they were roommates. They were roommates.
While that's happening, Themis is gonna turn to the group and go, "Do not split up again."
No promises.
No plans to after what happened today.
It turned out fine today, but we can't always guarantee that.
Splitting up was a lapse in judgment. We should not have done that. And we will not be doing that again.
Barry, you would know this specifically, especially well. The reason that these three are alive is because the kind of venom that these spiders use, they don't kill their prey right away. They let them marinate a little bit in the webs until they need a snack.
Gotta keep it fresh.
If there had been anything else, those three would have been dead.
Can I kind of like observe the room?
Yeah. Speaking of which, there's still a.
That's what I was going for.
That's what I was going for too.
Oh wait, there's a. Oh, okay.
Demas, you wanna check that out, or do you want me to?
I will gladly do so. I'll waltz over there and I'll investigate the cocoon of webs.
Yeah, so there might have been a body still in here an hour ago.
Oh.
Also, I would like to say that was the cultist corner fabric I was aiming inside? For with fire.
Talking over each other makes it a little bit difficult to understand. Kat, what was that?
Sorry. That's the corner I was pointing to with fire. It's just gonna say.
Yeah, okay, and the room is full of webs.
Makes it much better.
Intentionally trying to set anyone else.
It's like a gunpowder trail.
Yeah, just setting a stranger on fire.
Oh, I'm gonna use druidcraft and unlight Cat's torch.
I feel like after an hour, it would have been snuffed naturally.
It's true.
I'm just making sure. That there are no just, yeah, or
just
anything.
Sure. Just really make sure. There you go. All right. So the body that was in here did not have cultist fabric.
What the hell is here?
When you say that there might have been a body in our, were they alive?
As in, like, it might have been a little bit more recognizable. You know what? Themis, I'll give this to you. Make a history or a perception check.
History or perception.
I have a -2 in history.
Is it currently dim light?
No. Yeah. Victor has a torch.
That's cocked. God damn it. Okay.
And well, I was going to say, this particular thing is within your area of expertise, so if you feel like you need advantage, go ahead and take it.
Take it. That's more like it. 17. Perception.
These clothes are one of a noble.
Ooh.
That's concerning.
A sashless noble.
Not somebody from the Ivory Ward.
Ah, okay.
Famous, as you're looking at this a little bit more closely, you realize you've seen this person before.
Oh, no. It's not as...
The person in the who was down here happens to be the father of Eliza Dorr.
No!
Who you had met with
no.
just the other day.
What the hell?
This is Damien Dorr's body.
Yes.
Sir Dor.
You guys, this is Damien.
Why was he down here?
But didn't we just see him?
We did.
Like, yesterday?
We did.
That's spooky.
Which begs the question, why was he here precisely, Kyrus? Why was he here? Why was he in Radiant at all?
I have a question.
Yes?
Who was this guy?
So, Victor, you actually already know who this is because you've been following the case. The initial casualty was a young noble lady by the name of Eliza Dorr. She passed away in a freak accident with some sort of crystal monsters in the Violet Thorn Inn, of which, of course, Themis is the owner of. This group has been pursuing the truth behind the case. And not long ago, they had stopped to give condolences and ask a little bit of questions of the father, Damien Dorr. And, well, as of yesterday, he was alive and well. He was the one who gave the group the lead about his sister, Lisa, even though he didn't believe it. He suspected Lisa Dorr, but he did tell the group about that. He is, as for who he was a part of the Dorr family estate, which owns vineyards outside of the city, and did a lot of the customer work. So actually setting up deals with selling the wine to different places. Now he is definitely dead.
Okay.
Amos might have some trouble getting wine for the inn.
Oh, that will be of no concern. I'm sure we can secure a supplier rather quickly.
I don't think that is the issue to be thinking of right now, though.
Yeah, precisely. So sad and solemn right now, guys.
Am I allowed to go and check the body? Unless it's already been, like, checked.
May investigate the body if you would like.
Okay.
Are you just searching the belongings, or are you trying to, like, search the body and see if there's any, like, you know, makeshift autopsy sort of deal?
Can I only do one?
You can do both. I just need you to tell me what you're actually doing.
Okay, probably just to check, like, the body for now, like, to see what's the deal. What happened?
Go ahead, then, and make an investigation check. And I would also like you to make a medicine check. And tell me what you get for each.
12 and 7.
So, you can see that it looks like the spiders, when he got here to the spiders, he probably was already dead on account of a mark that you see on his neck. That was clearly the injection point for something. You don't know what it was. Unfortunately, you didn't score high enough with your health. But it does look like he was potentially injected with something. And then presumably brought down here.
I see. Can I tell the party this?
Yeah.
So they're in the loop. So I explain pretty much everything you just explained.
I feel like I'm in a mystery novel.
So can I do a medicine check to see if I can see what's...
Yes, you may.
All right. So I guess I should move over here before I do that, eh? So that is a 19.
What you notice when you walk up to this body is that, yes, they definitely had spider venom from the spiders, but you notice something else. There's a little bit of discolored black skin around the knuckles and on the feet. And you know of a poison that does this. The plant that is used to make this poison doesn't grow so much around your area, around the West Track. But you do know that up to the Northeast, if you take the Bear Trail, you can find the plants that make this. Although even then, it is not a very common thing to take and make, because the refining process of, in order to get somebody to straight up die from it, is not something you can do with your average herbalism kit. So whoever did this was either extremely motivated or had money to pay somebody to do it for them.
And of course, I relay this all to the group.
I do not know what they did. I do not know what they deserve. Why they deserve this. But someone is targeting their entire family.
That's for sure.
It may have been in response to our inquiry.
It very well could have been in response to our inquiry. You are absolutely correct.
Are they trying to cover their tracks?
They're not doing a very good job of it.
And it seems based on the signs that Damien did not come here voluntarily.
I think it's less of them trying to cover their tracks, and it's more of a threat to us. A warning.
And we have to double down, huh?
I'm sure they knew we were gonna go here to Radiance. Why else would he be here?
Is it a trail?
I'm not
sure. Momo an insider?
How many more people are going to die?
Certainly a lot more if we don't find them quick enough.
Yeah.
Where was the poison from? And would they have to be close to it to get it? Or somebody in the area of that? Is this something that's over there and people are experts of? Where we could see if maybe if they had somebody paid to do it, could have been somebody over there near the plant, right?
I have no clue what the circulation of that plant is, so I couldn't say.
Actually, Tore, you might recognize.
Well, we haven't been given a name, so I'm not sure if I would know what it is yet.
Null knows the name.
Yeah, it is Raven's Ire.
Okay, do I know anything about that?
You do know about Raven's Ire. It grows in a bit warmer climate normally than the area immediately around the city. So if you took the Bear Trail, you would have to go not significantly north, but you'd have to go through the mountains a bit, take the mountain pass up to the northern side of the island in order to really be able to find where it grows.
Okay.
And yeah, so the process for making the poison as well, Tore, you would recognize having Barry point out the actual blackening of the knuckles. It takes just a twinge of magic in order to get the poison working. at least if you want it to work fast. If you don't want it to work fast, then of course you can always just use it. But the little twinge of necrotic magic would make it work instantly. And given that you saw him a couple days ago and he did not have black on his knuckles, or mm-hmm. at least as far as you remember, whoever did this might also have some sort of magic ability or contacts.
Yep. Okay. So we're dealing with magic users here. Possibly maybe a higher up in the cult or something like that. I don't know if the people we were fighting against were able to use magic at all.
Or the Ivory Ward.
That too. But I still don't think we can definitively say whether it was somebody from outside of the town. They could have brought somebody in. Or it could have been somebody who learned it here.
Lisa had done favors for the cult.
Yes, but she was restrained yesterday.
That
so I don't
of.
Think she would have, well, that we know of, yes.
How possible would it be that this had been done yesterday before we found her? And how possible would it be that she did not know what she was doing?
Well, what was our timeline for meeting with him and then meeting with her?
Was it even on the same day?
Yeah, I think
believe it was on the same day.
Okay.
Was it?
So if we, I'm pretty sure we went to visit her shortly afterwards, so she would have had to do it and then make it all the way back to Ivory Ward.
You guys move so fast. I don't think it was on the same day. I think that you guys visited him and then went to visit the prisoner, or the other way around, and that was one day.
Yes, and then we went back to the inn, and then the next
and
day.
And the Ivory Ward was the morning.
Yeah.
This is why you have to have the VODs up.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm trying.
It's not off the table, then. That's a possibility, but.
Okay, clarification. Do you need the magic on the person or on the poison?
I don't think it's on the poison.
It's on the poison. It's not a very high level magic. You just need to use some necrotic magic during the. I mean, it could be a cantrip, right?
Yeah, it could be like
so.
Toll the bells or something.
Right.
Anyone in toll their mother could do it. Then.
Toll the dead. Sorry.
Well, magic isn't like the most common generally, but here in the city, with a lot of people who have links to the Ivory Ward, if not directly are members of it. Yeah, it gets a little harder to nail that down.
And like it also could have been like done the poison and then it's injected to him, right? So like it doesn't have to be after it's injected, right? To make it work like that?
Correct.
So
poison needs the necrotic magic.
So this could have been done at any time. It was just injected after
any time after
him.
We met.
Yeah.
Yeah. But does I don't think.
Well, I'm just establishing that it's possible that Lisa
it
was asked
possible.
To like do magic to a vial of liquid that she didn't know
well,
what
that's
it
true.
Is.
That's true. Yeah.
Like, I'm not saying she injected it herself, but it's possible that someone just put a bottle in front of her and said.
Well, we can go.
Can you bless this or some shit?
Yeah. Well, I think we should go. Obviously, bring this.
Yeah.
To the city guard, of course. And then ask some more questions to Lisa. But do we want to do anything else while we're in here? I don't presume that cultist is still running around hiding. He might be.
Do you think that spider had any treasure?
No.
Also, did we check his corpse's, like,
if he had clothing?
And he had clothing on.
I hope, but like...
I hope so.
You mean like search through his
personal stuff. Effects.
You may make an investigation roll for that if you would like.
Okay, I will do so.
We need to retrieve his body and return it to his family.
Keep in mind, Victor is actually part of the guard, so it's not like...
Okay.
Yes.
I didn't know that. Can we check for a sigil on his clothing as well?
Oh, yeah.
Or what's your investigation roll?
My investigation roll, I rolled a 14.
Okay. Now, you're vaguely aware of the symbol that they're talking about because it was part of the case insertion. It is a circle with a hand in the middle. You do not see it anywhere on this body. Or on the clothes. Or anything like that. As you're going through his stuff, you do find his coin purse. Contains a hefty amount of gold that you'd have to take some time to count through. Not a ton else. It seems like he was mostly traveling light, but maybe with an unusually large amount of gold.
A bunch of money.
Ransom.
A bunch of money.
Ransom money.
All he had was a bunch of money.
Does this city allow bail?
No.
No. Okay, so he wasn't trying to like bail out Lisa. Is he in like relatively like daytime clothing?
His noble threads are a little bit, they're high quality, but they're a little bit less flashy than
maybe an evening time activity or something.
It's also
he was
possible.
Trying to be discreet.
Yeah, he was trying to be discreet.
Mm-hmm.
He wanted to see if the cult could get her out.
He was ready to pay them however much it costed, because he thinks she didn't do it.
Maybe we could go back to their estate and ask if he told anybody where he was going or what he was doing.
That's definitely something that we should do.
If we're even welcome there.
Well.
First we come bearing bad news of their dead daughter and interrogate them about that. Now we're going to bring news of a dead husband?
This is an official case at this point.
We could have the guard set up security for the estate to attempt to protect them.
That would be a good request to make.
I could help with that.
All right, well, do we have anything else to do in here?
I don't think so.
I will.
I'm ready to leave if you are.
If we leave, are we just going, or are we going back up to where we were before, or?
What about his body?
We have to bring it back.
I know. But it's not going anywhere either.
We don't know that. There were spiders.
Take it with us, just in case.
There were spiders in this room we're standing in. There could be more.
There could be cultists that want to dispose of evidence.
So we have to bring it back today.
Okay.
Right now.
Just hoping we can get some more information, but I guess not.
Not it.
Not it.
Somewhere. What do you mean, not it?
I'm gonna take it in
my body.
I can try.
Victor, you are a member of the guard. It is less suspicious looking if you do it.
But if I can just...
It's not very strong.
I could just clear you guys.
Yeah.
Clear y'all.
What are they gonna do if I say no?
At any rate, we're gonna look suspicious. We are...
A bunch of...
You're helping. You're helping.
Suspicious.
That is one way to put it, yes, but we are also very much flashy, to say the least.
Not you. You look like shit, dude.
Oh my god. The town is... the fucking town paper is gonna... like, the town tabloids are gonna fucking post articles about how Themis walked out of the cathedral looking like shit, covered in shit water.
Covered in shit water and orange paint.
I can already see the headline. Is this your beloved tavern?
No. But we've got town criers. That news is going to go like right now if you walk out the way.
Themis likes to run around in the sewers.
Likes to run around in sewers, comes out in orange paint and drenched. You have to hold
out
that.
Ask if you're part of a cult, you know.
Yeah.
I could turn into a mastiff.
No. I have a disguise kit. Can I possibly disguise myself as someone who is not Themis?
And this is why, in every campaign, I will always try to take prestidigitation.
Okay, I don't have prestidigitation as Bard. Hello?
I know. Oh, man. Disguise kit. Well,
I'm proficient in disguise kit.
Yeah, but like, you don't... I guess you could take the clothes off of one of the cultists.
Wait, sorry. This is pretty... I think this is... So magical things glow, right? It glimmers?
A little bit.
Man's is gonna look shiny.
So, I guess this would be pretty obvious if you have a high enough perception. Hold on.
Disguise kit is not the same as disguise self.
Hold on, let me ask you this, Moo.
You're talking about your...
My clothing.
Your clothing. Roll an arcana check using your spellcasting modifier.
No. I just want to see if it's obvious enough, if I can do this.
Yeah, you're generally pretty sparkly.
Okay, so they would already know. Okay, then I'm just gonna use it.
Okay, you watch as Themis kind of takes his clothes and twirls it around and just turns it into something that doesn't look like shit.
Is this like a magical girl transition?
Yeah, so specifically he
that
takes
is exactly
out,
what it is.
He takes
you
out like
see
a
him,
cloak.
Like, his entire body erupts into light, and then it just like, you know, all the clothes just like from nowhere attach onto his body.
He's not wearing
360 panoramic shot.
He's not wearing, you know, whenever like super celebs would go into the airport and they're wearing like super like head to toe in black with like joggers and sweatpants and like sweatshirt,
that
and then they
airport.
Have like a black mask, like black sunglasses, and then they have like a fucking bucket hat that covers the rest of their face. That is what Themis is wearing right now.
Oh my gosh, at that airport fit.
That airport fit, yeah. Themis is wearing the airport fit. It still slightly glimmers because it is a magical clothing.
No, it's just glitter.
Well,
Man's is glitter.
I think. Who took a spill before? Tore did, right?
What? Me?
You fell into the water before.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so you'd still have a little bit of... I mean, you've been resting for a bit, so it no longer is damp, but it does not smell great. Also, you
Lovely.
Were, like, clinically dead for a minute there, so...
Does perfume surely exist in this world, right? Yeah, but...
Sure, for, like, dead bodies and stuff.
Themis still wouldn't carry it. Like, even if it is, like, a... Even if it exists as, like, a luxury thing, Themis wouldn't just fucking carry around a bottle of perfume. That's expensive as shit.
Can I use the herbalism kit to make something that makes Tori smell better?
The only resources you have at your disposal is that weird ivy that makes people like the statue more, so I don't...
I don't suppose we have a source of fresh water in here, do we?
Fresh water? Probably not.
Okay.
We can have another dip of the... like.
Where is a pally when you need one to create fucking holly water to dunk you in?
Holly water.
Yeah, holly water, not holy water, holly water.
What did you need for that?
Holy water? Okay. It's counterintuitive because to make holy water, you need a drop of holy water.
Hmm.
You get to buy some, and then you can make
I'm gonna
more.
Start carrying holy water.
But with Xanatars, you can do a ritual that then create holy water out of nothing, but it is a ritual that takes like an hour or something.
Do we all have, does everybody have water skins in their kits?
Most of you guys
should. Yes.
It's like half a gallon, I think, if it's like 5 pounds for the skin and the water.
It's 4 pints of liquid.
4 pints? Okay, so it's literally half a gallon. We have 2.5 gallons here.
Okay, Themis just walks up to you and goes, "Stand still." And he pull out his water skin and then just dunk you in so much water from it.
I will do that to myself as well.
You are now soaking wet again and you smell a little less worse.
Nice.
A little less worse.
A quick shower. Yes.
Worse than the rest of you who have paint and blood all over you?
Would the faint odor of skunk make him smell better?
Now wait a moment.
You got 2 options, skunk or sewage.
No, I actually, that's one of the things that I can do with Druidcraft is I can create an instantaneous harmless sensory effect such as falling leaves, a puff of wind, sound of a small animal, or the faint odor of skunk.
Well, it's instantaneous.
I guess it's not lasting. No, that's true.
I'll pass.
And it says such as. I could actually probably make it smell better.
You could make it smell like flowers, and you're like, nah, let's go with a skunk.
Yeah, you could just do that instantaneously every time we pass somebody. Like,
don't smell us. Tori. Do not perceive.
Yes?
Do you happen to have your tea bags in a waterproof container?
Did you say tea bag?
Do you happen to have your teas in a waterproof container?
Is this DVD?
Or are they drenched in sewer water now?
Oh no.
I presume they would be in waterproof, like wooden capsules or something.
The item that you use to carry around the other stuff, the other capsules, I would imagine would be waterproof because it would really ruin your tea if you got rained on otherwise.
And it should be in a hard container because if I'm going to squish up against a wall and I want to crush everything.
Mm-hmm, exactly. So.
Very well. Just wanted to make sure that the next that time you brew tea...
Would you like sewage tea?
Unfortunately, all of your rations are pretty much useless. And your torches, tinderbox, and bedroll won't be usable for a little bit.
You might
want to wash that bedroll.
I will tell.
You might want to wash it. Anyway,
I will send for
doing.
A replacement for you, and Hector will surely replace your rations. He seems to have taken a liking on you. At any rate, we should leave. It's rather dangerous.
I will try and carry the body.
I don't know what Themis looks like, Clausy.
Themis, your rations are also ruined. As well as your white linen tablecloth that you have for some reason.
It was for aid.
It is now a much more brown linen tablecloth.
Is it big enough to wrap a body? Because I ripped out a strip.
You're gonna wrap him in a
That's just nasty.
Table?
No, okay. Just put
he's,
it back in the
he's
webbing.
Not gonna know.
Put it back in the webbing. Just roll him up in all the webbing. It's like a body bag. It's a body bag.
People are gonna think it looks like a body anyways.
Yeah, there's no changing that.
But covering is for decency. Oh wait, it's sewage covered. You're right.
Yeah, exactly. That's the anti-decency. We have enough cobwebs.
Jesus Christ! I rolled a net 20 to carry him.
Okay, then
all
you're
right,
carrying.
You just pick up the body.
The anti decency innator.
Jesus Christ!
I mean, how the reason strong I was... is Kyrus?
Yeah, Kyrus
can be strong when she wants to be. She only has a plus one, but that's okay.
Wait,
better than my like minus two.
Wait, you are a pally.
Mine's
hold on.
Also minus two.
You are a pally.
Yeah, I'm a paladin.
No, you still wouldn't be able to make holy water.
Nope.
Still not sure what holy water is, but yeah, so
no, I'm doing it on purpose. It's holy water. It's not holy water.
I know. So I assume you guys at this point will head out of the sewers here.
Yeah.
Yes, please.
I'm gonna find my
guys,
spear on the ground wherever I dropped it.
If you want to come back up the way you came, it was a little out of the way, like tucked around some buildings. It's not like on the main street, or definitely not on the main square. So you would be able to wait there if you wanted guards to escort those of you helping with the body. Or you guys could just walk through Radiance with the corpse.
I would like to wait.
We should wait for the guards.
Maybe we should wait.
Yeah. So in that case, I will say probably your best bet is with Victor going to grab some of the local guards to help you guys escort you back into the inner circle and to probably straight to Watchful. So let me move back here. So you guys, of course, are in here. And you will have to make your way down to the main trail, like down here, and up to Watchful, where the guard is. A bit of time passes. Anybody wants to take that time while you guys are traveling to do anything or converse?
So, Victor, you said you're working this case?
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Can I ask why? Like, what? Were you just stationed on it? Or did you want to take this case?
A mix of both, I'd say. One, it's my job to handle
obviously, yes.
Things. It's I don't know.
Were you just drawn to it?
In a way, yeah.
I see.
And did you work as more of a private investigator? Because usually the guard doesn't do things with a single person.
Yeah, I'm a detective. I'm not really,
Your station isn't quite the same as, like, the guards that patrol. And most of the time, your services are completely unneeded because there isn't, like, a whole ton of crime that needs to necessarily be solved. Normally things are pretty cut and dry. But yes, whenever there is some sort of legitimate mystery where the facts aren't quite clear, that would be typically something that you take up by choice. But you're also kind of expected to do that by the guard captain, anyways.
Yeah.
Sorry. The guard also does not normally have to deal with the potential involvement of a member of the Ivory Ward in murder.
I'd like to ask Barry what he saw in that room that I ran out of.
The statue room.
The statue. It's evil.
Okay. what was it a depiction of again?
I mean, I don't just know specifically. It was just a demon of some sort.
Okay. Is that enough to make an inference that what they're, what the cult's involvement with is probably infernal in nature?
Well, it's weird because the hells are not connected to the world same way that the Fae isn't connected to the world or the astral plane. They've all been separated. So the depiction of a demon is very out of place.
So we can presume that's significant.
Yes.
Okay.
Like maybe they're trying to break through the barriers as well.
Something like that, perhaps.
With more sinister intent.
Moo, would I remember, what do I remember? Like, would I have remembered a time when that realm was shut off?
So, let us pop into Whispers real quick.
Okay.
The cats are watching the hamster.
The what?
That's concerning.
The cats are watching the hamster.
You know, I thought you said washing.
Yes, the cats are washing the hamster.
Keeping them clean.
Discord has an update, and I'm trying very hard not to update it. It's like a big red button.
I understand the struggle of not updating it.
It's very tempting. I literally cannot update it right now. Why did they push an update in the middle of our session? How rude.
Yeah, don't they know? Don't they follow the channel?
Exactly. Actually, it was before the session, but I know, right? How dare they?
It was not before the session. I updated before the session for sure.
It was. Oh.
No, Teams doesn't have any facial features. He's got.
Man's is just a white boy.
Yeah, he's got no face. It's got no eyes, no nose, no mouth, no facial features at
Slenderman?
All.
He's actually
Slenderman. He's Stan. But yeah.
My body is in pain.
My brain is in pain.
I'm like falling asleep.
What are your opinions on thermochemistry?
I don't think I have one.
What the?
No, I just randomly had Moo start coming through my headset.
Yeah, yes. Same happened with me.
Glad it wasn't just me. I took my headset off, so I didn't hear any secrets, but, you know, and I reconnected.
You just have to reconnect it.
Yeah. That was weird.
I'm glad that didn't happen for me.
It's crazy because I have everything set to none the whole time.
Yeah.
So did I, and it's just started coming through.
Love that roll 20. That's
man, I was spacing out, design. So.
Great design, roll 20. Please fix that. Thank you very much.
Too bad you can't, with Discord, you can't do like you can with Zoom and like create breakout rooms.
Oh, the breakout rooms are so good.
You can, you would just fuck up layouts, which will not be an issue in the future because we will be moving away from Discord because I am working on something. But no promises as to when that will happen because I refuse to pull another week where I sleep maybe 15 hours total in the past 3 days.
Yeah, you better not. You need sleep.
Yep, I do. I'm going straight to bed after this session. The gravitational pull of my bed is going to be so strong, I will not wake up. I will be in a fucking short coma for the next 16 hours.
What do you mean, will be so strong? As if it isn't right now?
It's not. I'm working. I'm on the clock. I'm on the clock for this channel.
Lore of D&D is too strong.
No, I don't care about the lore.
Lure.
Oh, lure. Kind of.
I cannot speak well.
According to my Twitter, Discord went down like an hour ago. So
oh, yeah, no,
it did. I couldn't text.
What did y'all hear?
Not much.
Nothing.
As soon as I recognized Moo's voice, I popped my headset off. So.
As soon as I recognized Moo's voice,
I was
scrambling my mixer.
It might be Nova because you reloaded while I had you in whisper mode.
Yeah, I reconnected because I was having a little issue and it might have just popped in for everybody or something.
That's so dumb. Well, at any rate...
It's kind of the worst.
At any rate,
actually,
the stream would not have hurt anyway.
Okay, could everybody reload their roll20 really quick?
Sure.
Just refresh it. Couch, you don't have to completely redo the entire thing. If you just hover over your own little icon, there's a little refresh thing that you can select.
Have not seen it.
Maybe you have to have your others can hear or see stuff on the voice, but because here's the thing, did you guys refresh your connections when you started hearing me?
I just clicked reconnect.
Yeah, I just clicked reconnect.
Yeah,
because I was in the whisper with Tore and it was all of a sudden your guys' images, because normally it like whites it out. I think because he refreshed while I was in the whisper, it like really messed stuff up.
Okay, well, nothing was heard on stream. I just checked the VOD.
Told you this. I don't have Chrome piped in to OBS.
Okay, cool.
It's almost as if I said it.
Everybody,
I didn't hear you say it.
Could you set your others can hear or see voice and I can hear or see voice? Just put them both on voice really quick, reconnect, and then put them both on none and reconnect. Because right now.
Everyone?
Yeah.
Okay, I did it.
Okay, I did it.
Done.
I can see you. I can see you. I cannot see Kyrus. Pastel, are you?
I think mine were.
There we go. And now I just don't have Victor.
Wait, what am I supposed to do?
In settings, go to audio and video. Others can hear or see, put it to voice. I can hear or see, put it to voice. I just gotta make sure that I can, because I can see you all, which means I can whisper you all if I do this.
Okay.
I can do that. I can do that. Do that. If I put you all into a whisper like that, I'm just checking to make sure I can do that. Okay, and I still don't have... Still don't have the option to do that with Victor, but I do see that you're muted, so... All right, that's real weird. You can put them all back to none and refresh. Gotta love the Roll20 issues, even when we aren't using it to frickin' do hardly anything, it still manages to fuck up.
It's impressive.
Honestly, it really is. It really is impressive.
I'm trying to... something feels wrong. I might just, like, refresh the page for a second.
Okay. Anyways, just to get back on track, you guys are on your way to Watchful. You do see some looks, especially when you pass through the inner circle. It's not an everyday occurrence, necessarily, that somebody is taken from Radiance, especially given that it's full of people who have a little bit of divine magic, and a lot of them have the ability to help heal.
How many of knowing glancing looks do we get? Like, people knowing who it is that we're carrying?
Do you... So you don't have him covered at all? Well, the guards would have him covered. I think the guards would probably...
Yeah, something. Okay.
Yeah, the guards would probably have wrapped him. So nobody has the exact details on that. But if nothing else, then we can take you to... Watchful, it's probably late afternoon, given all the time to travel to Radiance to investigate the area. Going through the sewers, taking a long short rest, etc. So, you guys arrive back in Watchful. Now, Victor, you'd mostly stay in the Outer Ring, but you've been to Watchful a couple times. This is the other sector where the guards... of the inner circle, the inner city, live, and where the office of the guard captain is, of whom you've met a couple times, but you're very rarely needed for actual detectiving, so... But, alright, you guys arrive, and... as the other guards help bring, the body in for inspection, the guard captain meets you all in the front waiting room. Well, that's not the development I was expecting.
Either we were not expecting to find another body of the Dor family.
Someone really does not like this family.
He was injected with poison.
Injected? What?
Yes, there was a spot on his neck. What was it? Raven's feathers or something? What was it called?
Raven's ire.
Raven's ire.
You see the guard captain kind of furrow his brows a little bit. Not a super common poison for people in the city to know of. It's mostly something that you would recognize if you spent a large amount of time in the places that it grows and had to, avoid eating something that would kill you. So it doesn't seem all too familiar.
I'm wondering where it's grown.
To the north of the Idria. The collection of isles we're on.
To the north of the Isle of Zithia.
Oh, okay.
The one that you guys are on. Yes. So actually, let me take you into the island map, because I don't think that couch has seen this yet either. So, here's your guys' city here. And basically there is a small pass off to that comes off the city, which is the bear trail that kind of passes up through the mountains and goes through here into more swampy forested area down here. And it grows in this area. It grows a lot more in, well, the rest of the island. And then it grows a little bit in here and over here. That's where Albarian would have some experience with it. But it's mostly north of the mountains.
Are there any, like, more populated areas where this plant grows?
No. It's considered very, very dangerous to be around, because even though it doesn't kill you instantly if you ingest it, it is not something that you can very easily cure without either very, very, very experienced, you know, physical herbalists or magic. And magic isn't amazingly common outside of really Hollowstar.
Do you know of any suppliers that might have brought it here? I think his name is Matthews, right?
Most of the trade inside and outside of the city is actually monitored, so it would have to have been smuggled, and we have not caught anybody trying to bring poisonous material from past couple months. I'd have to check the records, but I'm relatively sure that, I mean, I haven't seen an incident like that for a while. The what you can and can't bring inside the city is pretty clear to most folks who are visiting.
And does the poison require fresh plant material?
You would know this, Tore.
I'm asking you.
Oh, gotcha. It doesn't necessarily need to be fresh. It needs to be within a week of the berries being picked.
Okay, so if he's... I'm just asking, because if he hasn't seen an incident in the last, you know, I assume it's been more than a month or so, we don't need to worry about checking that, because it's not going to be within a time span that is worth checking. I'll take your word for it, Matthews. We don't need to look through those records at all, because this happened recently.
Hi.
We were wondering if we could question Lisa Dore again, just because of the timing of this, and because that poison to act so quickly requires a bit of magic. We were wondering if she might have any knowledge of what happened there.
All right.
I turn to Tore and I speak in Elvish. Be patient this time.
I was going to recommend that you talk to her instead, actually.
Me?
Yeah. You're the charismatic one.
Yeah,
I'm not.
Oh, Lisa!
I have a minus two, okay?
I have a plus four.
Pastel, oh. You do not play the plus four.
You don't play the face of the party, Pastel, so I feel like
I have the capabilities.
Okay, well, do that, because I feel like I'm initiating a lot, but I'm supposed to be the guy who doesn't talk.
Start running the plus four, please.
I'll try.
Kairos, would you care to speak to her?
I can, yes.
All right. He's allowing two of you to go back to talk to her, if you wish.
Would anybody like to join me?
I can.
Okay. Yeah, no issues there, as you are already in the case. So, all right. He brings you back through a hallway, and you can see what looks like a very particularly built cell. It is not, you know, a bunch of iron bars in a room that you saw before. This is, it looks like an actual room with a solid door. You can see runes inscribed on it. As he opens it and as you enter, you, Kairos, feel that you cannot use magic in this room. Fun. You do not have the ability to.
Okay.
You see Lisa Dor sitting on a relatively cushy bed in the room with some nice natural sunlight coming through the harsh iron bars in the wall. And she kind of looks up slowly.
Hello, Lisa. I sadly come bearing bad news, but questions as well. I'm being attacked by a cat!
Was that the bad news or the question?
Yes! It wasn't Barry, I swear. You'd know.
Was it
While
Momo?
While looking for clues, we found your brother Damien dead. He was poisoned by Raven's ire, and we wanted to know if you know anything about it.
She looks down at the floor and doesn't respond.
Please, we just want to get to the bottom of this. Even if you don't, just say so, but give me something.
Anything.
Maybe if you have any help for me, get out.
Go ahead and roll insight checks, the both of you.
I rolled a 17.
18. It looks like she is almost like emotionally retracted into herself and is ignoring you.
Can I go up and sit in front of her?
You cannot. There's a separation in this room.
Can I get as close as possible?
Sure.
Do you know anything about what happened to your brother, Lisa? Did you do this to him? I look towards Victor for support.
We need to know this. We need to know if you did it or not. This is to help clear you. You need to have this understanding. Any information that you have about what has happened will help. And we need information.
She begins to shuffle and turn her back to you both.
I guess you're not leaving anytime soon, then. Shall we take our leave, Victor?
I think that's all we can do.
I will proceed to Nier's.
As you follow her out, Victor, you just catch the small sound of crying as the door closes behind you.
Wow.
The guard captain takes you all back to the rest of the group.
He didn't say a word.
Nothing.
Well, he didn't even seem fazed by her brother passing.
She hasn't really seemed fazed by anything.
It's possible that she has difficulty expressing her emotions. We can't necessarily put that against her.
This is true.
It's hard to interview somebody when they need a little bit of emotional help and they're locked behind a cell. It's kind of tough. I think we did the best that we could.
Unfortunately, with her as our only prime suspect, there's just not much we can do. I'm going to ask and task you, Victor, to go search the Dora estate.
I understand.
Gather whatever information you can from there. At the moment,
yes, sir.
Yeah. It's not looking great for their lineage. As far as I'm aware, the father of Damien is still alive and well at their actual estate to the east. And his wife is still, I believe, traveling back from a visit to her family in the Marches, so she may return, at which point we will have to give her that news.
I have a question. Do you have any laws about using high-level necromantic magics in this city?
Most high-level magic is typically prohibited from use outside of special chambers within the Ivory Ward. Pretty much all magic is banned from the streets, at the very least, except in cases of purely self-defense, or sometimes spectacle, but those are less often. Necromantic magic in particular is... He looks very uncomfortable mentioning it. He says, technically, not illegal, but I would advise against it.
And why is that?
Generally not viewed as it's a big conversation in the city, for sure.
It doesn't need to be if nobody knows about it. I'm wondering if we can get a prime witness if we revive our Mr. Door here for a price in the Ivory Ward, if that's possible.
That is strictly forbidden.
Ah.
Tampering with human nature and the laws of life and death, as I said, not technically illegal, but I doubt you will find anybody willing to publicly do that. And it would have to be public, as this is a case. So we would need to know. It's not a terrible idea, but unfortunately, the ends don't always justify the means.
Understood. That's all I had.
Also, the injection was in the back of his neck, not the front, so it's entirely possible that he could have just been snuck up on.
Thought it was on the side. I didn't know where it was. I was just assuming, like, the side of the neck. But yeah, that was. I was thinking about that. He might not have even seen anything.
So we were all listening to that car, right?
What?
Well, yeah, you're in here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Anything else?
Have some thoughts. I'm gonna keep.
I don't know what the next step would be. Do we go back into that basement again? Keep looking around or something?
No. The next step is to search the dwarf family.
Yep.
Okay.
And I would also like to our point out
condolences
that at the beginning of the session, Victor managed to recover a scrap of paper burned, but with part of a word visible.
Could I take a look at it?
And an empty book, right?
Yeah, then an empty book.
And Victor, look at the.
That's word. All that is on the piece of paper.
Oh. That's helpful.
Is it the back half of a word or the front half?
It's burned on both sides.
Can I take a look at the book?
I'm gonna assume it says crystal.
Rista.
Rista.
That could very well be crystal.
Can I take a look at the book?
Yes, Victor hands you the book.
Can I determine the nature of this book, if it's magical or if it's been tampered with?
So, it's not magical in the way that you would recognize. You know something's weird about it. You don't know what it is. But also, the effect is so small that it's not necessarily something that pings a large amount of alarm.
Could it have been used by somebody who was, you know, using magic? Is it like leftovers or is it like just weird?
The item itself is magical. It's not used for anything.
Okay. So it's just an empty magic book.
Do I get anything? Because I'm pretty adept at magical stuff.
This is a foreign magic. It is like asking to describe a different language. Straight up, not attached to the weave at all.
How important is it to keep this book untampered right now in terms of evidence?
What sort of guard? Are you asking him? Yeah.
Well, it doesn't have anything in it, does it?
Does not look like it.
It's blank. I don't know that we can necessarily draw much conclusion from it.
In that case, could I borrow a pen?
All right.
And I'm gonna write hello on a page.
Hello.
I wanted to say something really edgy, like you start to write the word, but you can't finish it, and it just says hell.
Hell.
but no, the ink doesn't even adhere to the paper.
I'm going to try to do it again in Elvish.
No.
Okay. Well, that
was that word on the paper in common?
Yes.
Could you write crystal in common?
I'll try that.
It doesn't necessarily seem to be the word or the language, but ink is not working.
Mm-hmm.
Normal pen ink.
Yeah, I'll try blood.
Like, what about blood, man?
Sure, I take my dagger. A dagger?
Before we go to blood, do you want to try honey?
Why sure. not?
I'll pull out my non-magical dagger, I'll dip it in honey, and I'll, like, try to write crystal.
It does seem to be having the same effect of flowing off the paper, albeit at a much slower rate.
Okay, I'm gonna like hold it vertically and wait 5 years for the honey to drip down.
You may all take a long rest. Just kidding.
And once it's clear, I'll take a different dagger, my magical one, and I'll score my hand so that there's some blood on it, and then on the dagger, and I'll write crystal on the page with the blood.
He's silent. Oh no.
1 second.
It just occurred to me that I probably shouldn't have used my own blood.
Oh no. Who would we use?
I can't tell if this is a good second.
Pull
or
Momo
like
out of Eden's
second.
Hair.
No, it either way, whoever blood we use, it would not end well, I don't think, for anyone.
She checked DMs.
Wait.
I'm scared.
I don't know. What would it be made of?
I think that's what it would be. It would... you know what I mean. But I think you would know.
I would know, right? Because this is me forgetting my lore. I would know, so I wouldn't do that, right? Wait, no,
something
you're right.
Else?
You're right. There's no way he would carry that, right? Okay, yeah, that would be it. Yeah, he would carry that one inside. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. We're good.
You, touch the blood to the paper, and it does adhere. But as soon as you're done, as soon as you lift up, whatever implement you were using to put blood onto the paper, it just sinks into the paper and disappears.
I knew it. I knew this is Voldemort's soul. I just didn't know what activates it.
I was gonna say, are you pulling a Tom Riddle on this?
This is for sure a Tom Riddle book. It's just, okay, it's blood instead of ink. Okay. Huh? That's certainly something.
Did anybody know how to see blood that's invisible?
Blood book.
I have a question.
Now suppose you have a UV light. What's up?
Can we take a break? I need water.
Yeah.
Yes, we can take another 5 minute break here. So, a Tom Riddle book real? Well, you know, maybe. We don't know necessarily what's going on with the book.
Does anybody have the identify spell?
We have a paladin.
No.
I have detect magic.
Well, we already know it has magic, so.
I don't have identify though.
Paladin? Wait, Pally don't have access to identify? No, that's third level anyway. You don't have third level yet.
Nope.
We could go hire some of the ivory ward.
You're a half caster. You won't have third level for a while.
Yeah.
Nope. I think we could hire somebody.
Gotta love a group that don't have identify.
Didn't we get the rich guy's money?
We're not taking his money.
We're not taking his money.
The Boris state.
Hello. Hold on.
Hi. Victor, if you need money, Themis has all the money.
All right. I'm going to take a break though. Five minute break, real quick. You guys may continue discussing your thirst for stealing people's money, even when there's
Themis.
What is he gonna know?
Wow,
Victor, if you need money, Themis.
I don't need it, but like, take from the rich, give to the poor, you know.
But Themis is the rich.
I take from you too.
All right, he'll just go home and take another bag of 500 gold.
Man.
But yeah, let's hire somebody to identify and hope their eyes don't burn out when they do.
Okay, so we should definitely identify it, but I want to know if right now we can, like, maybe rewrite a question.
I don't have anything that could show invisible stuff, I don't think.
Well, next time I think I'm gonna write a question and see if there's an answer and go from there.
What if we set it on fire?
Oh, don't.
What if you splash it with water?
Then it'll be gone. No.
It's magic. It might not be
flammable. Okay. But if you do, you might burn part of an entity's soul and make it angry.
Yeah, it's magic. It won't break. Yeah, okay, fucking Taliesin.
Would it drown? Can we drown it?
No,
I don't think it itself is an entity.
You can absolutely break magical items.
Yeah.
Like, if you put, like, water on it, would that do something to it?
I think it would just drip off a little bit with the ink.
It's waterproof.
Okay, I gotta go. I'll be back in 30 seconds, and then we can...
I freaking smashed my hand into my vision.
I'm gonna be right back.
There's only one way to find out whether or not water would break it, but one answer is not an answer that we would like, so I think we don't find it out.
Oh god, what are you all talking about?
They're wondering if we could break it by setting it on fire or dunking it in water.
I wasn't thinking break it. I was thinking see
what would happen. Well, there's two options, right? It doesn't break, or it's on fire now and it burns to ashes. I feel like one answer outweighs the other here.
Or it could reveal something,
or it could burn to ashes and we no longer have a magical book of unknown nature.
Let's identify it.
Wait for identify, or we could like rip a page and burn the page, although ripping it could also set something off, which could be bad.
I think Unlike all of our last campaigns, we should try caution first instead of ripping and chasing.
Yeah.
Caution? What?
We should definitely...
Especially given last week. Let's do caution first.
I was just thinking the same thing.
Yeah, we should identify it. We should call a guy for identify. You're right. Themis is not gonna write with a question with blood. No.
Yeah, the more you write, the more chance there's for something really bad to happen somewhere else that we don't know about.
Yep.
I don't suppose an arcana check would do anything.
But the arcana check was kind of what...
It was saying it's a foreign magic, basically.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so we want to identify that first, or do we want to search the door estate first?
Well, not everyone's back, but...
Oh, we don't have everybody. Okay.
Yeah. Also, it's like late afternoon right now, and in order to identify it, I assume you guys were saying you were going to go find somebody.
Mm-hmm. In the ivory ward, presumably, or somebody nearby.
Yeah, you'd need to get...
That takes like 8
Dustin
hours.
Back. And he's...
Can we just ask Destin to like get someone from the ivory ward to come to the guard station and we identify
there? Can
he bring
them to us? We're the federal government right now.
I don't...
Nope. Not how it works.
We also kind of don't know if we can trust anybody in the Ivory Ward at this point.
We're gonna have to deal with Sneeze Guard back again.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay.
Sorry, I'm back.
I'm also back.
Well, Tori, you better wash your fucking rope, because we're gonna need it.
Okay.
My legs hurt.
Kat, are you back?
I've been here. Sorry.
Well, you're muted.
You're muted.
So you don't say that you're back, I'm then here. You're not back.
Hi. Hello. I have Kat. My eyes hurt. My cat's left me.
Okay. Well, are there any magical items that let you cast Identify, like, once a day?
You mean, like, the Moonlight Identify that I had in the first campaign?
Yeah. Literally, I had to give it to you guys.
Can I have a cleric?
No. We have economy on our side. A little walking can't hurt us. Get your rope.
We have economy on our side.
Wash your rope. Get your rope ready.
Okay.
Wait, better yet.
Are we going to Gilded Gate first?
Why would I hate you?
Oh, you'll find out.
It's the blood, isn't it?
Anyways,
it's the blood on the book. It's the blood on the book.
You guys are gonna go.
We're in the book at this point.
Yeah. I think we're going down to the Dora estate because we don't have time
Can
we stop by the inn and take a long rest?
You can rest for the rest of the day, but it won't be you'd basically take the rest of the day off. So it's not like you can go take an 8-hour rest, get up at midnight, and then go around like you have.
You have to wait.
You can with a search warrant.
They
just won't
No.
They just won't be happy. No, I just don't want anything to happen to their estate while we're not there, so I want heavy guard presence there.
I think it's still a good idea.
You can request that already. You don't have to go there.
And we'll request that so that nothing at least happens, or at least nothing happens unnoticed until we get there.
It's also a good idea, even if we wanted to do that now, it's still a good idea to stop by the inn because we're covered in shit water right now.
Come for a shower, bro.
Some of us are covered in shit water right now.
Coming on me,
yes. Some of us are covered in blood.
And orange paint. And you know what's funny? Barry is covered in absolutely
nothing.
Because he...
Christine.
he managed to get out of all of that.
Oh, relatively unscathed, too.
Barry took all of one hit that entire encounter the past two episodes.
No, I got bit by one of the spiders and I did 3.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, you took all of 4 damage,
but you were also wild shaped.
Yeah.
Wild.
All right.
To the inn.
To the inn then. You guys can head back to the Violet Thorn Inn for Victor, this is the first time you've been inside. Relatively cushy. It's in Silverbrook. It's a fancy commercial-ish area of the inner circle. So it's very high end.
All fancy.
Well, because of all this business so far, Themes has been relatively generous on allowing people to keep rooms. You guys walk back in and you see Hector behind the counter. Yes. Hello?
Hi, Victor.
You mean Hector?
Hector?
The name is Hector. I mean, I can't blame you for forgetting, but...
I'm sorry. No, I'm sorry.
I thought we were close.
It's too late. No! Hector, I'll have the strongest you have and a straw, please.
Another souvenir straw?
No. Oh, well, I'll take out my straw. Well, I don't want to use my straw.
Wait, your straw is covered in... your straw has been in the sewer now. We'll get you another souvenir straw.
I can replace that or wash it for you if you'd like.
Do you want me to use druidcraft to set it on fire?
Maybe not.
And burn it?
Maybe not.
That's made of wood.
Yeah.
Put it in the fireplace.
We do have a fireplace. You are correct.
I'll just get you another straw. It'll be okay.
I'll just get you another straw.
I had grown attached to that straw, too. A shame.
Well, this one's not covered in shit now, is it?
Yes, fair enough.
Hector, we will need to send another condolence package to the Dorf family.
Another one?
Yep.
All right.
We will also need to look for a different wine supplier, I would assume.
What do you mean by that?
Yeah, what do you mean, man?
Damien is no longer with us.
Right. Oh, I mean, theoretically, we could still go through Darien. Damien just managed the books, I think.
It's
but
still a good idea to look for backup, just in case.
Yeah, it's good to have insurance. Did Damien have a son?
He did.
Okay, well then it'll probably go to him, but just in case something happens to him.
Just in case.
Get insurance.
A lot of things could happen at this
point. I know
that's
morbid sounding, but we're being realistic here.
Okay, I guess I'll look around and see if there's another supplier that can make up. I mean, they did supply us with a lot.
They did. I will also be on the lookout as I travel.
Aye. Well, also, anything I can do for the rest of you while that's being taken care of?
I have some water.
You got like half a stick of bread in your mouth.
Of course.
Thanks.
Victor's helping himself to the amenities.
Was that supposed to be a big ask? I mean, it's a tavern, for God's sake.
We
half of our beers qualify as water anyways.
That's true.
You said that in front of your employer?
No. Themis knows about this. It's a tavern. You have the shit beer and you have the good one and you get what you pay for.
So tell me, what's your beer to water ratio when it comes out of the tap?
Well, you know, actually in most places around the island, beer is preferred to water because they don't have such a clean source of drinking water like we do here. And the distilling process actually kills a lot of the nastiness in the water.
Mm-hmm.
Get sick less.
This is called grog.
So you have
so
you have water beer and then you have like I wanna get drunk beer.
Yeah.
Okay.
I get wine drunk one day.
Do you
that
just not
fun.
Have hard alcohol in this establishment? Because if you want to get drunk with beer, it takes a lot.
Well, obviously, but you want
that
it to taste good.
That depends on the person, Nova.
What, Pastel?
That depends on the person.
Oh my god, wait. Can we change something? Can we say that Themis always carries his water skin filled with, like, hardcore liquor? And when I dumped it on you, it wasn't water.
I just smelled like rum for the next 2 hours.
Yeah.
Well, you know, there's it's alcohol. I mean,
people passing me on the street thinking I'm a hardcore drinker.
Well, you know what? I can recommend you something, Tori, if you'd like. We have this newer product, Jack Daniels.
Ah,
it's back.
New on the block now, is it?
I'll have oh boy!
That just had a comeback.
I've been waiting to use that one.
Couch, you don't have a context, but
okay.
Actually,
that has to be.
What's going on?
That has to be from Themis's personal stash, right? Hector is just pulling a bottle from Themis's personal stash and like handing it over to Tori.
Oh, for everybody else in our original campaign with
This was middle campaign.
Oh, it was
yeah, this was Lost in Space campaign.
It was Lost in Space.
Yeah, because I have no idea what you're talking about.
Gotcha.
Remember it was Herb's thing, remember?
Yes.
We didn't have money for that kind of drink in
That's true.
The original campaign.
I am missing a sock!
And we are missing context.
Thank
you
for that announcement.
Anyways.
Yes, in the space campaign, the intermediate one that we played. That is an inside joke. So,
my character, Herb, was like an old gangster halfling, and he pulled out a bottle of Jack Daniels. The finest whiskey in the entire galaxy.
Finest whiskey. I'm so sorry. I'm matching my socks. Because I need to finish my laundry.
D&D. Nah, let's do laundry right now.
I'm sorry, I would like to go to bed after this, and there's the laundry sitting on my bed.
Hey, I did chemistry homework the first hour of session, but I didn't need to do anything.
You can roleplay while doing anything.
Exactly. I mean,
for fuck's sake,
Gene.
I'm running a broadcast while roleplaying and taking notes, so.
I've been taking
notes.
None
of your notes are on World Anvil.
I have them.
Uploading
them, no. You can shush.
No, he's talking about mine.
I guess.
thanks to our one viewer, Ro, for going along with the rest of what we're talking about.
Anyways.
Hi, Ro.
This conversation gave Barry an idea.
Uh-oh.
Distilled mead.
Oh, no.
Ooh. Oh, people have done that, actually.
Yeah, I'm... It's called Somel, S-O-M-E-L. Not entirely sure how you pronounce it.
Interesting.
The world may never know.
Some people also call it honeyshine, because it's basically moonshine.
Of course, Sonova would know that.
Look, I've watched distilling videos in the recent weeks, because it's cool.
Anyways. Rein it in. Anything else from those of you in the tavern?
I just get something to drink. I need something after today.
Yes, same.
All right.
Might as well leave the bottle here, Themis.
Strong, please.
Lens,
you know what?
Please.
You know what? I don't need water.
I don't need water.
You know what? Hit me up with the same thing, man.
You're being rude.
Yeah, I'll take a third.
It was vodka all along anyways.
All right, before you finish that bottle.
Oh, I wasn't going to. I was just going to have like a small old fashioned.
No, you can have the bottle. It was imported.
I wasn't going to.
It was imported and it is in my personal stash, but you can absolutely have it. Let me just grab a glass for myself to have in my bath. And then I'll pour a glass and then I'll just go to my room.
Crisp Jack Daniels. All right.
I have a custom item called Jack Daniels Finest in my inventory.
Yes.
Anything else? Can I... you see that Hector serves out many of the drinks. He kind of like... raises an eyebrow to Theme. It's like, you know, every time you come by, we end up with less and less of the upper stock.
We'll get another shipment soon. It's fine.
Hopefully.
I hope this isn't coming out of my pay, that's for sure.
No. Why would I do that? We can just upcharge everyone else.
Of course.
They're all rich.
Ah, business.
Easy problem to solve.
Well, you might lose customers after the recent incident, but...
Most of that was blown over. Here's the thing about the people who have a lot of money. As soon as something's not directly impacting them, they don't give a shit. In fact, if it's impacting another noble family, they're all over it. Of course, yes. They don't care about the Dora family. They don't care about anybody but themselves and their wallets.
And listen... they're never gonna stop.
You're not included, of course. I absolutely wasn't talking about you.
Oh, you can include me. It's fine. It's probably the same. And listen, they're not gonna stop coming here just because something happened. This inn has a reputation. This inn is the it place. They're always gonna come here.
Considering that there's literally not another tavern in the inner circle.
Oh, exactly. Well, that'll do it.
I mean, and the closest one to here is Fiery Beard, and that is full of miners, and it's just absolutely atrocious.
And no one's going to try to make an inn to rival this. The people up there will not like it, because we bring in a lot of Texas.
Have you considered branching out locations? People from Common Ground have to walk quite a ways to get here.
Ah, well, Common Ground's really where they work, not necessarily where they live. And most people who work there, also, it's not like they have the most money. I mean, it's elected officials that have a little bit of money, at least, enough for campaigning around the other areas, but
you know how much stress they have in their daily lives? They would drink your place dry.
Would they be able to
afford it?
Besides, there's taverns.
I've never seen finances stop anyone from drinking.
You know, most of the miners are up in North Road. Olifirebeard is by far the most popular. You still have got taverns, especially along the main four routes, the Bear Trail, the West Track, and the South Road. There's a little bit in the Sword District as well, but they're mostly smiths there. So there's still places to go and drink. This is mostly for the much higher up clientele, not the common rubble, as they would say.
Besides, I would not dare to change the tradition of this inn. It was passed along to me, just like it was passed along to the previous owner, and the previous one, and the previous one.
Is it not in the family?
No.
No.
Okay. Is there like a competition?
No.
You know, I don't actually know, Themis. How does it go down?
I was just given the inn when the previous owner wanted to retire. I was working for him.
Well, Hector, you're in a good spot, I would say.
You're certainly next in line.
No kidding. Assuming I don't, you know, get taken out by a crystal monster.
We wouldn't let that happen to you.
Well,
I sure hope so.
We would have said the same thing to Eliza.
That is certainly a risk. I will not lie, that is a risk.
He puts his hand over his face as he laughs at that comment.
I'm sorry to be realistic, but we would have said the exact same thing and I didn't stop it.
Protect Hector at all costs.
Okay, wait, we know Hector has been drinking out of that bottle, right? Like at work, he's just been sneakily grabbing out of Themis's stash and just like drinking the expensive stuff. Not that Themis would care.
Absolutely not. I could not serve people while inebriated myself.
You can clean while you're inebriated.
Maybe a little inebriated, but
I sure hope your pay is good, man.
Oh, it's well enough. I don't need to steal anything if I wanted a drink, to be honest.
Well, but we don't really get
good deal
the
working
good
for
stuff.
This one.
I mean, with all the like crystal monsters in your unit.
Listen.
Oh well, hazard pay is another thing. I mean, you only get hazard pay if you're working for the mages.
Hector, do you have medical
benefits? I don't know what that is.
I was gonna say, is that even a thing in this world?
Look, this isn't the United States.
Of course, you know.
Do you have insurance?
Blue Cross Blue Shield. I've got dental and medical.
Get your insurance, kid.
You got Aetna.
Aetna.
God damn it. Oh my god, the BBEG for this campaign is gonna be a fucking insurance landlord, isn't it?
It's going to be the U.S. medical system.
That's right. Taxes.
So true.
You
take, soon.
You take 35 tax damage. as he initiates a contract under your name.
Oh no. Oh no no no!
I tax him. Yeah.
No! You guys are just giving him a good way. You guys are just giving Mu a good way to nerf the economy.
And right, the taxes too.
He was lost because I'm playing a tavern keep, but now he knows how to nerf my economy.
Oh no, I have plenty of plans for that. I'm just letting you all have fun for now. The real drama won't happen for a little bit.
Well,
that's
mildly
concerning.
I won't have.
It's only the destruction of a family for now.
I also have won't like.
Yay!
I also won't have access to my.
Mm-hmm. When you travel.
Yeah, I also won't access to the purse while I'm traveling because I mean, realistically.
Stuff it all in the couch purse.
Yeah, I was about to say you could stick it on the couch of holding, but it's going to be hard to get back out.
Yeah.
The problem is you can't reach in there for coins if you want coins.
Do you lose 75% of what you put in just by its nature?
It's a significant amount.
Listen, Themis is rich, but he's not like 75% loss rich, you know?
I mean, you had six figures. That should cover everything, right?
Not if we keep putting it in all of his purse in there.
Just continuing to chant the couch now.
We have a tax goblin in the chat.
Bro, what is with you and taxes?
Honest taxes, Ark.
Oh my god.
So
where were we?
I think after I get quite inebriated, I'm gonna go to sleep.
Go ahead and make a constitution saving throw.
God damn it.
Actually, but you, Krios, and Victor all had the same thing to drink. Make some con saves.
Oh no.
No, what did he give them?
You don't have to drink.
I got a 17.
What am I clicking?
I got a 15.
In on the right, or on the left side, I mean, underneath your stats, it'll say saving throws, and you can see CON, the con save. Click on that.
Okay.
Click on the modifier.
Oh, like, no.
Plus whatever.
I got a 4.
Oh, no.
So it seems like the detective can't hold his liquor, can he?
Is he on the clock?
Went slightly Irish there, Moo.
I mean, sorry? Hector is certainly slightly Irish.
You were slightly Irish there when you said that.
Oh, Hector's been talking like that the whole time.
Oh, I thought you were talking as Moo.
No, that's Hector.
Irish accent.
Wait, what did they have? Was it the vodka or was it the Jack Daniels?
It was the Jack Daniels.
Krios, what did you get?
15.
Do I need the take
okay.
one then?
So... Oh, no, you're fine.
You're drinking it through a straw.
I'm finishing the year right
through
now
a straw.
For engaging in illegal activities.
Hey!
Oh, I see what's happening.
Hey! No! None of that hilarious.
Yeah, y'all are 21.
Excuse me, it's
this Hollow
18 in Quebec.
No. That doesn't. All right, but still, Kyrus and Krios, you guys feel fine. But yeah, Victor, everything starts spinning, and you're like,
see on the
talking
flash.
From experience.
Maybe I'm not actually. I have never gotten that. I've seriously, well, I cannot. I fall
that one session.
No, one session where you, yeah, you finish an entire
bottle of
Fireball.
You misunderstand. That is just tiredness compounding. Like, that is just
okay,
what I,
but tired
when I'm
alcohol,
like, really tired, that's what that is. The only thing the alcohol
oh, man,
does is let it show
really,
more.
I was really, really tired in the Saturday buffoonery, and I was off the walls.
You
oh my god,
whoever's
sleep deprived passed out. Whoever's the sleep deprived passed out stage.
Yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Oh, where you laugh for like 45 seconds a minute?
While you were dying.
Oh, great.
From lack of oxygen in between.
Well, no, it's funny. Couch has experienced the worst of it because I used to stay up to like 4 a.m. with them.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all, youngsters. Anyways.
Speaking of couch, Victor, you fall off of your bar stool. And Hector kind of leans over and is like, I'm not going to have to help him to his room, am I? Does he have a room?
His best friend, will help him to his room.
Is he on the clock? Is he still working,
well,
technically?
He isn't anymore.
That's true.
He's not on anything but the floor at this point.
God damn it, no.
Fuck. Okay. All right. Anyways.
You know,
I need
you
to
could
take
just,
my meds.
You could just hear like some like little like.
Remember, Pascal. It's bad to mix meds with alcohol.
Stop picking on the youngsters.
Victor's just on the ground, you know, laughing like very little bit, you know, very clearly not okay.
All right. Well, is there anything else that I can do for you?
Does he have a room?
Hector kind of just looks to Thamus like, well,
if there's a spare one, I mean, what are we gonna do? He's on the floor.
Put him in some with somebody else.
I mean, the floor can be as well.
It might be a good idea, just in case, to have somebody keep an eye on him.
But I'm not.
Maybe keep him on the rooming with his bestie.
Wait, when this bestie. I take everything back. I am not bestie. So
if we're voting,
you
I
have to commit to the bestie bit.
Okay, fine.
You did say you were his bestie.
I made some adjustments. Yes, I did. And
you even invented that word.
Come along, bestie. And I'm glaring at everybody.
You see, like, a visible joy in Hector's face.
Tori's glaring at everybody, but nobody knows because mask.
Yeah. You can't
see. I'm just staring at you all.
You can
walk
feel
up the
it.
Stairs.
You can feel
you
the
see,
daggers.
Like, a glint of purple.
Oh, he's so pissed
Man,
off.
I'm
isn't
so
he?
Glad he made a friend.
Oh, he absolutely is.
Screw you!
This is
you
amazing.
Can hear me
from upstairs.
Alrighty, Krios, shall we retire?
Yeah, sounds like a good idea. See
then
you
all tomorrow.
Long day. Good thing you two kept your liquor in check.
We're fine.
I'll check.
I was
if gonna
say
still...
something, but I'm not gonna say something. You should
say that's
it.
What I was implying.
Well, then why did you
no.
say? Why did you
I
say?
Am not gonna say something.
Well, I'll go
no,
attend
I
to
the know.
Clientele. Famous, I presume that you're going to be out tomorrow as well.
It would appear to be so.
Well, if I'm going to magically inherit it someday, then, you know, might as well get some practice.
Precisely. Good thinking, Hector. I'll grab whatever's left of the bottle, if there's any left. And I'll go retire to my room
also,
and take a bath
can I make
with
it
a bottle.
Clear, just because Krios and Kairos are sharing a room does not mean they're dating!
I was gonna say vodka is already clear, but you were
talking about
something
else. Yeah, no,
they're
just roommates.
No, they're
not, they were roommates.
Hector does not believe
you. They were roommates.
Nobody believes you.
Nobody believes you.
So with that, I presume everybody retires to the room for the night.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Question.
Possible answer.
Who has the book?
Thamus.
Did Thamus not return it to Victor?
Victor shouldn't be held responsible for it in his current state.
I don't think... Okay, wait. Would Victor have asked for it back on the way back?
It was evidence that he collected.
Did you ask me for it back, Victor?
Probably not. I think that there's probably enough trust for you to just hold on to it. Because something happened when you used it.
So Thamus would have it.
Thamus, I would like for you to go into a whisper with me.
At least you didn't write your name.
I did not. That's true.
Good
like
for you. Well, he just wrote Crystal, so maybe he made another Crystal monster appear somewhere.
Or somebody named Crystal is...
somebody named Crystal just fell over dead. Okay. Well, Ro, we said the exact same thing. We said maybe it's like a Horcrux.
The death note.
Because the words Real disappeared death when he wrote in it in blood, so...
Hi, Polly!
It's like Death Note, but in reverse. He was actually writing about how Eliza Dorr died.
Yeah, maybe Eliza wrote her name in the book and she got killed. So maybe Thamus is going to get attacked by crystal monsters.
Guys, guess what?
Is Turkey
I have
in the
all
room?
Three cats.
I was a third, right?
I have Polly in my lap and the other two are on my bed.
Pictures.
No.
Okay.
My legs hurt. I want to go to bed.
Me too would like to go to bed.
Well, that's just too bad.
As soon as
that's too damn bad.
Might find out how dead Themis is.
Yeah. It'd be problematic if he's...
It's 8 p.m. Session's been going 4 hours. That was a good time.
Ah! I'm back.
Okay. And Themis is back.
Themis is back.
Okay, he's Themis alive. Is dead. He's alive.
I'm alive.
So, everybody, you go to bed for the night. You may take your long rest.
Stop trying to eat my sweater.
And sweaters aside, that is going to be the end of session for tonight because it is 10.
Yay.
So we have been up for about 4 hours. For next session, you guys have your plans. You want to go back to the Ivory Ward, but first you're going to stop back by the Door Estate to go ahead and investigate that. So I think everybody who has been keeping up in chat, Ro, especially you.
Thank you so much for watching
and for commenting. We will see you next week.
I'm assuming that my temporary hit point modifier from before we went into the sewers is gone now.
It's way gone.
Yes. Yeah. Anybody who had 8. So, there we go, guys.
We will see you guys next week for episode 6.
And don't forget, if you guys want to watch more D&D, if you're not just interested in our channel, there is a second channel that I play on as a player. I will be playing tomorrow, probably. You can actually see them in chat right now. Dungeons for Dummies is the one that we play on, and I play there as a player on Fridays and Sundays, if you're interested in more D&D. So, with that being said, see you guys next week.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.